production of Sports West Productions, your source for local college sports. Has New Mexico defeated Air Force in four consecutive games? They can do that today. Last year, quarterback Casey Kelly enjoyed a career afternoon routing the Falcons 52-33. But two games into this season, the Lobos are still struggling to find an identity. The Air Force Falcons are fresh off a 52-3 win over Northwestern. The victory came easy, but it left Fisher Deberry wondering, is Air Force really that good, or was Northwestern that bad? We're about to find out. New Mexico at Air Force next. It's homecoming at Falcon Stadium, and all the pageantry of life here at the Air Force Academy is front and center. A beautiful, hot, and breezy afternoon for the New Mexico Lobos and the Air Force Falcons. We've been waiting a long time for this one. Hi, everybody. I'm Dave McCann, and we welcome you to another season of college football here on Sports West. So here we sit on the first Saturday in September with a game that could change the rest of the season for these two clubs, because it's the first conference game, and these are two teams projected to finish in the middle to lower part of the conference. And Blaine Fowler, that is precisely why it is such a big game, because these teams want to win the conference.
That's right, and if you ask the head coaches, they wish they could play their first conference game later in the season. But since it's here, it becomes very big. If you lose, you go home and you worry about it, you already got your backs against the wall and you're behind in the conference race. If you win, on the other hand, you can kind of sit back for the next couple of weeks and say, hey, we're the conference leaders, at least for 2 weeks.
We are very eager to watch Quincy Wright run the football. He ran all afternoon last week against Weber State. He's a senior coming out of nowhere. Rocky Long calls him the surprise of the team.
Boy, he just bided his time as a backup for a number of years. 265 yards on the ground against Weber State last week. A new New Mexico record. And this was all from a guy who wasn't even an honors candidate in the media guide at the beginning of the year. You looked at his numbers on the season. Expect to see the ball in Quincy Wright's hands a lot this afternoon.
The Lobo defense has dominated Air Force the last 3 years. So why does Bronco Mendenhall tell us this week he's nervous about this football game? Leotis Palmer is one of those reasons.
Well, the New Mexico defense always likes to take away the perimeter game from the Air Force Academy. Leotis Palmer is the guy that will threaten out there. He catches the pitches from the quarterback. A tremendous athlete, one of the best athletes on this Air Force team. He won the Mr. Intensity Award for his work in the offseason in the weight room. A 42-inch vertical jump, and Air Force would like to see him loose on the outside. Last week, only 7 touches, 53 yards, but look at that 7.6-yard average and the touchdown. If Leotis Palmer is having a good game, then New Mexico's defensive game plan is not working.
So the battles of the Mountain West Conference begin. Air Force and New Mexico kick it all off, coming up live here on Sports West. This Sports West College Football presentation is brought to you by Panasonic Wireless Phones for the way you live. Delta, everyone has a reason to see somebody person to person. That's the reason Delta flies. Verizon Wireless, simple, affordable, national, join in. And by your local Lexus dealers, who invite you to test drive a Lexus today. Welcome back to Falcon Stadium. This is the 20th meeting. Air Force leads the series 11-8, but the Lobos have won the last 3 games. They've never defeated Air Force 4 in a row. The stadium has been buzzed by 4 sets of fighter jets. Emotions are high, and the conditions just right, 81 degrees. Make that 5 sets of fighter jets. Wind gusts out of the south at 10 miles an hour. Air Force won the toss. They defer to the second half. The Lobos will get the football first. Quite a setting here at the Academy, Blaine Fowler.
Boy, and you get a take a look at one of the fighter jets that just came over. They came out of the south instead of 10 miles an hour like the wind at about 600 or 700 miles an hour. And what a thrill it is. I've been on this field as an opponent to play against the Air Force Academy, and I can tell you that it is intimidating to stand down there as those flyovers come over and you get a sniff of the tradition that exists here at the Air Force Academy.
Joey Ashcroft will kick it off for Air Force. He's the nephew of the Attorney General. Talk about being connected. And back to receive for New Mexico as the kickoff is presented by your local Lexus dealers, who invite you to test drive a Lexus today. David Hall and Brandon Ratcliffe back to receive for the Lobos. And there's Joey Ashcroft. Kicking game, a big question mark for both of these teams. We'll see how it plays out as the Mountain West Conference battles are underway. And the Lobos will start from their 20-yard line. And our first look at quarterback Casey Kelly.
Like Casey Kelly, a former walk-on. He's a returning starter, made his way into the starting lineup midway through the year last year. And he had a big game against the Air Force Academy last year, tore them up through the air, and he hopes to get off to that kind of start tonight.
324 yards and 3 touchdowns against the Falcons. We asked Fisher Deberry what Air Force must do to prevent another kind of repeat day. He said get pressure on Kelly and get it to him on the very first play. Counter on the first play. He gets plenty of pressure. He's caught back in the backfield for a loss of 3. It'll be second long. The Verizon Wireless starting lineup. Verizon Wireless, simple, affordable, national. Join in. Look at that offensive line. Lensmeyer, an NFL caliber player, according to Rocky Long. Backs and receivers, Counter and Manning. The key for the Lobos is to get the ball to those two. They haven't scored a touchdown yet this season. They are the big playmakers for this Lobo attack. So it's second down and 13. A loss of 3 on the run by Counter. Play action, more pressure. Kelly unloads, caught for a short gain, and it'll be third down and long.
Let's take a look at the defensive starters for the Air Force Academy. A new look this year. They're running a 3-3. Monty Coleman, the most experienced with 8 starts, and a young group at that defensive line position. The linebackers, the strength of this defense, both Schlegel and Hightower are captains, and the secondary led by Overstreet, who Fisher Deberry says could be the best defensive back they've ever had before he leaves this program, and that's saying something.
Brian Penley on the reception, third down and 6. Kelly has it in and out of the hands of the open receiver, and a fourth down coming. Joe Manning had it and dropped it. And it's 3 and out for the Lobos.
Well, Fisher Deberry told us that after they played Hawaii last year, he and Richard Bell got together and talked about changes that they needed to make on defense to play better against these spread offenses. And they knew they were going to have great linebackers and defensive backs, so they changed up to a 3-3 alignment. They played with 5 or 6 defensive backs on every defensive play and try to confuse the offense. They did a good job on this series.
Flags fly, kick nearly blocked, but the walk-on Tyler Goss gets it away, and Leotis Palmer calls for a fair catch at the 2-yard line, but a flag is down way back on the 23. So we'll hold up and see if Air Force wants New Mexico to kick it again. A 38-yard punt. And it is motion against New Mexico. The Falcons came very close to blocking it, but they will decline it. And they'll take the ball.
Offense. Not enough men in the line of scrimmage. That penalty is declined. First down, Air Force.
So Air Force will start the ball at the 43-yard line, and our first look coming up of Chance Herridge.
Boy, Chance Herridge is everything that Chuck Peterson, the offensive coordinator at Air Force, likes in a quarterback. A good decision maker. He runs hard. He's a physical player and really became a leader in this offseason. Gave up his leave, his only leave this summer. Stayed on campus to work out and organize the 7-on-7 drills for the team. So he's really emerged as a leader, and he had 94 yards on 16 carries in the opener last week against Northwestern.
Question mark at fullback. Steve Massey makes the start. He's a junior. Dan Schaefer out for the season with a knee injury. And a pass on first down. Man's wide open. But Harris led him too far. It's incomplete, second and 10. Anthony Park, a junior out of Las Vegas, the intended receiver. The Verizon Wireless starting lineups on offense for Air Force. That center, Wayne Southam, served a two-year Mormon mission to Germany. The human cannonball, he's known at. We'll get more on Wayne a bit later on. Strecker, one of the best tight ends they've ever had, according to the Falcon offensive staff. We'll keep an eye on Adam Strecker. We heard about Leotis Palmer just before kickoff. So second down and 10, flags fly. Our first look at Massey, the fullback. And he's wrapped up by Terrell Golden and company for no gain. Offsides against New Mexico.
And for New Mexico, a good stop there on second down. And they're going to lose 5 yards and replay that down.
Good officiating crew. We met at breakfast this morning.
Defense. 5 yard penalty. Repeat. Second down.
Let's look at the defensive starters for New Mexico. And they run a similar gambling defense. Hey, Bruce Josie at nose tackle, the strongest man on the field. The linebackers, the experienced part and strength of this defense, led by Charles Moss. And a secondary that hasn't seen a lot of option.
On second and 5, Harridge in trouble, and down he goes with nowhere to go. The ball comes out. But the line judge right there to say his knee was down, and the Falcons will retain possession of the ball. Haybreeze, Josie, and Charles Moss on the attack. An interesting defensive strategy for the Lobos, unlike any other team that tries to stop this triple option.
Yeah, we've done enough of Air Force over the years. When you talk to defensive coordinators, they say, you've got to stop the fullback. You've got to stop the fullback and then take care of the outside game afterward. As you see the play, Bronco Mendenhall's philosophy is we're going to take away the perimeter and we're going to worry about the quarterback in the pitch. We're going to assume that the quarterback's their best player on offense and take him away first. And they've been successful for 3 straight years in controlling this Air Force option.
3rd and 7, right up the middle. Into the secondary. Leotis Palmer, touchdown. You get the feeling New Mexico is anticipating a pass on 3rd and 7, but not at Air Force. And Leotis Palmer, his second rushing touchdown of the season, taking it all the way to the house.
When Palmer came into this game, 964 career yards rushing, has a school record in the vertical jump, 42 inches, a great leader on that offensive team. And the Air Force Academy's offense is much more than just the option. They do a lot of things. You saw a little counter on that play. Very difficult to prepare for.
Ashcroft is good. Palmer, 54 yards for a touchdown. And the Falcons draw first blood, 7-0. Welcome back. 7-0 Air Force. Didn't take much time. 1:16, 3 plays, 57 yards. Leotis Palmer, 54 yards, right through the heart of the Lobo defense. So the second time Air Force kicking off here in the first quarter. The ball blows off the tee. And they'll tee it up and try it again. Brandon Gregory and Brandon Ratliff back to field the punt. Michael Greenaway kicking off. And it's another deep kick out of the end zone. So no return for New Mexico. Let's look at the game checklist presented by Wells Fargo Bank. The next stage, Blaine.
Well, for New Mexico, they want to control the clock. Last year against the Air Force Academy, they ran almost 100 plays and were able to keep the ball away from that Air Force offense and then throw the ball downfield. They've been throwing it underneath, but they've struggled to get it downfield. For Air Force, They need to make the right reads at a quarterback in that confusing defense, and they've got to get pressure on Casey Kelly defensively to make him throw the ball before he's ready.
Second possession for the Lobos. Haven't seen Quincy right until right now. And Air Force, Rick Fry, or check that, Eric Thompson, was waiting for him. Pick up a maybe two. Second down and eight. Ryder, senior out of Los Angeles, 265 yards last week against Weber State. Air Force is no Weber State, but that's still a very impressive day. The best rushing performance in Lobo history.
But if you look at this New Mexico offense, their offensive line is enormous. They go 312, 330, 280, 323, and 292 across that front five. And they did a great job last week of knocking Weber State off the ball.
Second down, Kelly. Man's wide open, and it's caught for a first down. Dwight Counter, junior out of Lancaster, California. And he beats Jeff Overstreet, and they move the chains. The concerns from this Lobo staff about Casey Kelly have not been the short passes, but downfield. They said they're going to try a few bombs today. Here he goes deep down enough to get the first down.
Right, an intermediate throw on a cross. And they've got to get the ball into the hands of Dwight Counter. He's the best playmaker on the football team. Runs a 4-4-3, 40. He's a big guy at 6'2". And he has not gotten the ball enough in the first couple of games.
Back to right, across the 40. Close to the 42. Overstreet on the stop for the Falcons. It'll be second down and about four.
When he was a workhorse last week, was Quincy Wright. 265 yards on 27 carries.
And he's all conference in track in the 100 meters. So
yeah, he's the fastest guy on this New Mexico football team. Ran a 4.3640. That is lightning, folks. Usually you see a corner or a wide receiver with that kind of speed. So that's tremendous speed for a tailback.
Miscommunication on the snap count. Casey Kelly wants an offsides on Air Force.
You mentioned that track. Quincy Wright, Dave, finished second in the Mountain West Conference Championships in 100 meters. Ran a 10.53 100 meters, so it's legitimate speed.
Prior to the snap, full start, offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
You can hear the wind on that microphone as we look at Fisher Deberry. What a career he's had at Air Force. 142 wins, 78 losses in his 19th season. He's the eighth winningest active coach, just four wins behind Dennis Franchione, former head man at New Mexico, who's now at Alabama. And the Lobos try to stretch the field and get outside. Not much for Rashawn Sanders. Wes Crawley, a senior out of Sacramento, knocks him out of bounds, and it's another third and long situation. Third and about 9.5. Rocky Long told us this club is looking for an identity. They expected much more explosiveness on offense. They didn't get it against North Carolina State, and they didn't get it last week against Weber State. Still scored enough points to beat the Wildcats. Third and long, Kelly all kinds of time. Wide opens Joe Manning. He's across the 42 where he needed to get. He's out close to the 49, and he's got a first down.
Well, Joe Manning had his career high in receptions last year against the Air Force Academy, caught 8 balls in that game, 26 total on the year last year, and he's just working his way underneath, coming all the way across the field from the right side underneath that Air Force zone, found a soft spot in there, and Casey Kelly was patient, had the protection, delivered a strike to Joe Manning for his first reception in this game.
Needed to clear the 47, got to the 49. Charles Akinyemi on the stop for Air Force. First down, New Mexico. Wright with a whole lot of room. Shakes one. Knocked out of bounds. Akinyemi saving a touchdown. A huge play for the Lobo offense. And you see Wright's ability to pull away from even the fastest players in the Air Force secondary.
Well, you bounce him into the secondary, and typically when you're talking to guys with 4-3 speed, they're little guys. But Quincy Wright is that rare combination of speed and strength, and he gets out here motivated. Watch him just run away from people. He's strong enough to pull away. Finally brought down on the other side of the field as the angles closed in on him that time, but He's a fine player with a lot of athletic ability.
Lobos marching at the 12-yard line. And it's right again. And this time, Air Force is ready for him. Nicholas Taylor, the nose guard, leading the way. 265-pound junior out of Cincinnati. And you see Wright trying to catch his breath.
And Air Force that time bringing the backers, bringing guys out of the secondary. That time, the left Falcon back, Joel Belo, came from the outside on a blitz. And the senior from Pulaski, Wisconsin, comes in and makes that tackle. He moved from corner to safety in the spring, so he's going to be a lot more involved in the run game than he has been in the past.
Loss of three. Kelly again, all kinds of time. Could have kept it. Instead, throws it inside the 10 to the 8. And Adrian Boyd has his first reception of the afternoon and sixth of the year. The junior out of Flint, Michigan. Wes Crawley on the coverage. It sets up a third down. Ball resting at the 8. And New Mexico can get a first down at the 2. On this drive, the Falcons have got very little pressure on Casey Kelly. Now it's Kelly pitching to right. In position with a big play and a field goal unit coming onto the field.
Boy, Marsh is the other Falcon back. You see Air Force Academy coming with a blitz, coming from the outside. And if anybody can defend the option, you would think that Air Force would be good at it. They see it every day in practice. They got to the quarterback, Casey Kelly, forced the pitch, and Marsh had pitch responsibility from his right Falcon back position and made that tackle.
Wes Zunker. He's 0 for 2 kicking field goals, missed a 33 and a 42. This one not near as far. And he negotiates the pull and knocks it in there, and New Mexico's on the board. So after giving up the big touchdown run to Leotis Palmer, the Lobos march down the field and kick a field goal, and with 7:22 to play in the first quarter, it's now 7-3. You're watching college football on Sports West, and we're back after a message from your local station. Seven to three, New Mexico tacking on a field goal, and the Lobos ready to kick it back to Air Force. The advantage rent-a-car scoring drive, 10 plays, 59 yards in 4:43, a 29-yard field goal. Ryan Blue and Alec Messerall back to receive it. This is Blue. Up close to the 28, into the pile he goes.
When you really saw the effect that that wind coming out of that south end zone had on that kickoff, it got up in the air. And actually, when Blue caught that, it was going back the other direction. That was a tough catch.
Domingo Villarreal on the stop as we look at other scores. From around the Mountain West, the Applebee's scoreboard, BYU a winner last night over Hawaii. Wyoming in a battle with Central Michigan in the third, tied up at 13. It's 7-3 here in Colorado Springs. One thing Air Force did to knock Northwestern off stride last week was score in their first three possessions. They're 1-for-1 so far. Leotis Palmer, he went 54 yards on his first carry. Palmer's across the 30 to the 31. Good for about 2.5 on this one.
I mentioned Air Force does so much more than the option. That time you see him in the eye, and they're just going a straight lead. That's something you'd see out of Michigan. And Chuck Peterson does a nice job with the offense at the Air Force Academy. They're not one-dimensional. They do a lot of things out of a lot of different sets. They have not thrown the ball much this year. But last week in their opener, only 7 throws from Chance Herridge. They'd like to see him throw the ball more. They think he can be an effective thrower.
Herridge back to Palmer. Knocked out of bounds. Sidney Wiley, excellent containment from the Lobos. And it'll be third down. We were surprised a bit to see Herridge throw the ball on their first play from scrimmage. It's been all run ever since. This Sports West College football presentation is brought to you in part by Panasonic Wireless Phones. Panasonic for the way you live. Third down and 4 from the 34.
And what Bronco Mendenhall does so well with that New Mexico defense, that he moves people around, he brings blitzes from different places, he keeps it difficult for the Air Force quarterback to make proper reads.
Aridge drops the screen ball off the hands of Don Clark, and a punting situation coming up for Air Force. Now the Lobos needed a good stop after the field goal, and that's just what they got. John Welsh, senior out of Georgia, will punt it up. And Dwight Counter, he took one back 63 yards for a touchdown a week ago against Weber State. And Counter will be waiting for it. Welsh will be kicking with the wind to his back. He should get off a good one. And he does. Counter will let it go, and it goes into the end zone. A monster kick by John Welsh with the help of Mother Nature, and the Lobos will have it. First and 10 from the 20, 66 yards on the kick. New Mexico has the ball when we come back. Welcome back to Falcon Stadium. 7-3 Air Force, 6:24 to play here in the first quarter. And a privilege to be with KRQE in Albuquerque and KXTU in Colorado Springs. And we're thrilled to have football back on Sports West for another season. Kelly, a keeper. For 1 yard, a lot of running for one. Faked it into the gut of right. And he gets one before Joel Belo stops him. It'll be second down and 9. Been waiting all year for this ball game, haven't we, Blaine? As soon as we found out we had the conference opener and two teams who were trying to get into that upper tier, they want to go to a bowl game, they want to win the conference. And with BYU, Utah, and Colorado State ahead on the schedule, and both teams still have to go to Las Vegas, almost a must win for these two teams.
Well, both coaches were hesitant to say that, but you could sure feel the importance of this game as we spoke to them.
Kelly out to Counter. He's called his number an awful lot here in the early going. And Counter comes down 2 yards shy of the first down. Jeff Overstreet on the stop, a junior out of Killeen, Texas. Fisher Deberry believes Overstreet could be one of the very best in the history of this football program in the secondary.
Well, he actually started as a freshman. His first start came against Notre Dame in his freshman year at Notre Dame. That's a baptism by fire, as Overstreet has been back there ever since.
Notre Dame will be here later in the year. Third down and 2. Wright has the first down and falls down at the 35. Trevor Hightower, junior out of Plano, Texas, credited with the stop. But another first down for New Mexico. And ever since that first drive of 3 and out, the Lobos have seemed to find themselves offensively.
And a good mix of run and pass. And Casey Kelly's looked sharp on his couple of intermediate passes out to Dwight Counter. Dwight Counter's got catches now. This is his 14th straight game where he has a catch. And he looks to be the go-to guy here in the first quarter for Casey Kelly when he needs a first down.
First and 10 from the 35. It's right again. 3 Falcons there to meet him. Matt McCraney grabbed his leg and just held on. He hit him low while 2 others finished him off up high. He's 2nd and 9. McCraney, one of the few seniors in this defense. A sack last week. Medical redshirt a year ago. Talk about a player just itching to get out and play football. He's happy to have this season.
He actually had he had knee surgery and actually had to sit out an entire year of school to rehab that knee. So he's happy to be back at the academy and happy to be playing.
Kelly is intercepted. Paul Mayo. And Mayo's inside the 20. Third interception of the year for Kelly. Had plenty of time to throw it. It sailed on him. And Mayo, in that zone defense, takes it 27 yards on the return.
And it looks like this ball just took off a little bit as Casey Kelly's back in the pocket. I mean, he threw it with confidence like he knew what he was doing, but the ball well overthrown. And the receivers both not even looking back to the ball. Take a look, well over the head that time of the receiver. Get another receiver on a streak on the right-hand side. But Adrian Boyd didn't even look back for the ball. It looked like he was surprised that the ball was coming out to him. And Mayo, the recipient of the gift, as he sat back in that zone defense for the academy.
First and 10 on the 17 for Air Force. Leotis Palmer met at the line of scrimmage and goes absolutely nowhere. He's second down and 10.
And Casey Kelly on the headset talking upstairs and trying to explain what he thought he saw to the offensive coaches in the booth.
Billy Struther in on the tackle, led the team and has led the team all season long in that department.
As a quarterback, when you make an error like that, you just sit there and go, come on, defense, bail me out here. Don't let them score because of a decision that I made.
More trouble for Harridge. That play action has not worked. And David Hall gets credit for the sack. Harridge stopped shy of the line of scrimmage, a loss of a yard, and it'll be third down and 11.
David Hall coming up from his safety position to spy Harridge on that one. JC transfer into this New Mexico program. He started 6 games last year, and the New Mexico staff says he's probably the best all-around athlete of the safeties. Combination of size and speed and physical strength.
Third and long for Air Force. Harridge to throw it. He had a man, but he threw it too far for Tom Heyer. And a field goal try forthcoming for Air Force. So after the long interception return, all Air Force can muster is minus yardage and a field goal try coming up.
Boy, and that is one of the toughest throws to make. That's a tough throw for a dropback quarterback, one that throws the ball 40 or 50 times a game, to throw that swing pass up the sideline.
Joey Ashcroft in. He kicked a 35-yarder last week for his only field goal try at the academy. This another 35-yarder. He's 2 for 2 from that distance. And Air Force cashes in the turnover for 3 points. And with 2:28 to play in the opening quarter, it is now Air Force 10 and New Mexico 3. A year ago in Albuquerque, Air Force jumped ahead 10-0 in the first quarter. New Mexico tweaked a few things, and then they blew the Falcons out.
Well, and if you're into that New Mexico defense right now, you're walking off that field feeling pretty good about what you just did. You had your back against the wall, came out from sitting on the sideline with your helmets off at a moment's notice out to defend on your own 10-yard line and held the academy to just a field goal. And I'll tell you, there's not a happier guy on the New Mexico sideline than Casey Kelly right now, because he feels like, hey, defense bailed us out. Now it's time to go and pay them back. So a good series for that New Mexico defense.
Scoring drive, 4 plays, minus a yard. Didn't take long to run those 4, and Ashcroft a 35-yard field goal. So Greenaway will kick it off again. He'll have to reset the ball. Real breezy day down on the field, which is nice up in the booth because it is hot and sunny. Looked like there were a bunch of rain clouds in the area last night, but this area just doesn't get much rain. Certainly hasn't this summer and fall. Now Greenaway is kicked 2 out of the end zone, and this is a 3rd. Well, we caught up with Fisher Deberry and talked with him about just how important this football game is for Air Force.
Well, yeah, that's a very important football game for us. They've sort of handed it to us the last 3 years. First year, Rocky and his staff came. We handled them pretty well, and then the last 3 years, they made it pretty rough on us. We've had some great ball games, but certainly they've come out on the positive end. So this early in the season, it's a very, very important game, you know, for us, and to establish some confidence in our program, and also being first conference game for both of us makes it a huge game.
Casey Kelly, well, he's not put out by that interception. His next time out, he's got a strike to Joe Manning. And a first down across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Joe Bielo on the stop. More on Fisher Deberry as we take another look at this play, Blaine. There was some reports in the Albuquerque area that Deberry had guaranteed a win this weekend for the academy. And we know him to be too smart to do that.
Well, as we talked to him, he says that was just absolute nonsense. He says, I've been coaching long enough not to make that kind of error, to give another team something to put on their bulletin board. He didn't say that, and But it somehow made the bulletin boards down there at New Mexico and was a big deal in the media down there in Albuquerque. He felt bad that he was accused of saying that and denied that he ever did. And we've known Fisher Deberry and Rocky Long for a long time and know that neither of those coaches would make that kind of guarantee even to their players, let alone to the media.
Joe Manning gets it up close to the 40-yard line, right on the 40. It'll be second down and three. Wes Crawley on the tackle. Casey Kelly's come out firing, 8 of 10. One of those, an interception. He's off to a pretty good day. Wright, off to a good day as well. Spins free. And another touchdown saving tackle by the Air Force secondary. Larry Duncan on the stop. But Quincy Wright picked up right where he left off, and suddenly maybe it wasn't Weber State's defense so much as Quincy Wright being a very good running back.
Well, you see everything on this play, too. First, you see his balance and strength as he pulls away from a would-be tackler. And then what's most impressive about Quincy Wright is his acceleration. Once he gets out into the open, he just starts to pull away from people. And the 5'10", 185-pound senior shows you that he can get it up the field in a hurry.
37 yards, already up to 85 on the game. He's on the sideline catching his breath. First down Air Force inside the 24-yard line. Dontrell Moore, his first carry of the game, and he dives to the 20. A pickup of about three. John Radzinski, sophomore out of Green Bay, Wisconsin, on the tackle for Air Force, and another steady, solid drive by New Mexico.
Well, and you got to give credit to that New Mexico offensive line. They've done a tremendous job. Kelly threw the interception, but he has not had pressure in his face yet in this game. And Air Force is going to have to get after a little bit and start bringing more people to accomplish what they'd like to do, and that's get pressure in Kelly's face, because right now that New Mexico offensive line is doing a great job.
Kelly to throw. Pass complete. First down yardage to the 11 to Jake Farrell. Mark Marsh on the tackle. The chains will move again, and Wright returns to the ball game. And Dontrell Moore out of Roswell High School, Roswell, New Mexico, he heads back to the sideline. So the ball at the 11, first and 10. New Mexico threatening to take the lead. Wright hit once, but it takes six Falcons to get him down. He's inside the 10 to the 9, so he picks up 2 yards. Time has expired in the quarter, so when we fire up for the second, it's New Mexico knocking on the door to take their first lead. Leotis Palmer's 54-yard touchdown run, the highlight of the first, and Air Force leads 10 to 3. Stadium in Colorado Springs. A sunsplash day, but a breezy one. We're ready to start the second quarter. 10-3 Air Force, but New Mexico is driving. Second down and 7 from the 9-yard line. Kelly to the goal line. It is caught. It'll be enough for a first down, not enough for a touchdown. Joe Manning takes it to the 1. The first quarter of numbers presented by Quality Sinclair Gasoline with SG 2000 is simply unbeatable, Blaine.
Well, you look, New Mexico dominating in terms of the statistics. 76 yards passing. Casey Kelly's looked comfortable. The rushing yards, Quincy Wright looks good. 165-57. Air Force with the big play on the first series, Leotis Palmer into the end zone. And then the field goal off of the interception puts them up in this game 10-3. That's the only stat that really matters, Dave.
Measuring for the first down, and it is, so The Lobos get a full set of downs to run behind a line of 292, 323, 280, 330, and 312. And Quincy Wright is licking his chops for a shot at a touchdown.
Well, and just the timing route that time, a three-step drop, a three-step speed out for Joe Manning on the outside. Very difficult to defend if it's thrown on time. Casey Kelly's actually releasing that ball as Manning's making the turn before he actually makes the entire break. And if the ball's thrown well, it's tough to stop.
First and goal. Kelly calls his own number. Still no signal. And now a late one. Touchdown. New Mexico has taken the lead here on the first drive of the second quarter. Just 9 seconds gone. And a leap over from the one. And that's the first rushing touchdown from Casey Kelly this season.
Well, and look at the big guys get down and low. He went right over that right side. Claude Terrell and Jason Lenzmeyer, two of the most physical guys on the New Mexico team at right guard and right tackle. And right over the top of Terrell's where he went, a freshman All-American last year for the Lobos.
Wes Zunker, good on the extra point after a shaky snap. And here in the early stages, it is now 10-10. A moment ago, I said New Mexico took the lead. My apology. They have tied it up 10-10 with 14:51 to go. But one thing we have noticed, since Air Force had the lead, there was an adjustment made, Blaine, and suddenly the Falcon offense is going nowhere, and the Air Force defense is not getting pressure on Casey Kelly.
And New Mexico's done a good job. They've had some success running the football here in the first quarter of this game, and now here early in the second quarter. And when Quincy Wright is breaking tackles and out in the open, everyone starts to get run-minded. That's opened up those throwing lanes for Casey Kelly to be able to hit Joe Manning and Dwight Counter underneath with those throws.
Impressive drive, 8 plays, 80 yards, and Kelly a 1 yard touchdown plunge to tie it up at 10.
Brian Blue and Alec Messerall are deep.
So Brian Blue and Messerall back to field the punt, or field the kickoff, but the way the wind's been blowing, I'd be surprised if there's any kind of return here. Blue has it, and there's no return. So Air Force will go from the 20. Expect an amazing season in the Mountain West. You look at some of the record so far. This is the first conference game. Colorado State off to a good start in non-conference. They're at UCLA tonight. BYU beat Hawaii last night. Utah's at home with Indiana today. San Diego State's over at Colorado. UNLV home for Kansas later tonight. And Wyoming is in a war at Central Michigan. Last we saw that, tied up at 13 in the third. First and 10 Air Force from the 20. Leotis Palmer on a little counter. Tries to get to the outside. Lobos are there waiting for him. Maybe 3 yards before David Hall knocked him down.
When trying to get to the outside with Palmer, and we mentioned that Bronco Mendenhall, the defensive coordinator for New Mexico, said we've got to take away that outside game. As Palmer tries to bounce to the outside, there's that swarming Lobo defense. And they've done a good job of taking that away other than that first drive. And one of the things that happens, you try to simulate this Air Force option in practice, and New Mexico in the previous 2 years has had a bye week coming into this game. This time they had about 3 days to get ready for this option.
Palmer, after dropping the ball, recovers and slips out close to a first down. It'll be about a yard short. Golden on the tackle for the Lobos. We third and about one. Near disaster here.
Take a look as Palmer gets a very fortunate bounce. It comes right back up to him, but slowed him down just enough to allow that New Mexico defense to get there and prevent the first down.
Brandon Radcliffe in on the tackle as well. So third and short. Herridge. Well, did they get it or not?
Where the mark came looked like he got it, and then as Herridge got up, he got shoved back to the ground by a New Mexico player, and then a flag immediately flew. And I would not be surprised to see an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, unnecessary roughness,
coach is just trying to get up, and let's see if we can see what happens. Harridge is getting back up and
help back down.
Well, and you know what? You couldn't really see it that well. You saw he tripped over someone, but he got a little bit of an extra shove. And Rocky Long, I'm sure, not liking that. He wants his guys to play hard and aggressive from whistle to whistle, but you just have to back away after the whistle is blown.
It would have been awfully close to a first down. It's an automatic first down from the 45. And some razzle-dazzle, and Palmer has a man wide open. Touchdown! Ricky Amezaga, first touchdown of the year, second in his career. And what a play. Leotis Palmer's first touchdown pass of the year as well. And New Mexico was caught completely surprised.
Boy, and it's so tough to defend this play because you're so cognizant of Air Force's option game, and you talk about defending the perimeter. Now the guy's coming to the outside. You've got to come up from the secondary. And Ashcroft puts it through to make it 17-10, but you've got to come up and defend the run, and Amezaga just sneaks by behind the entire defense for the easy touchdown.
Two touchdowns in less than 2 minutes. It's now 17-10 Air Force. Air Force wasting little time to answer the New Mexico touchdown. 80 yards in four plays and a 55-yard touchdown grab. And our first kickoff return of the game, Brandon Ratcliffe. It's coming across the 25. It's the first time anyone's kicked off into the wind.
Exactly. Let's take a look. This touchdown does two things for Air Force's offense. First of all, it opens up your running game now because the defensive backs are going to be very hesitant to come flying up knowing that, hey, wait a minute, they threw a halfback pass on us. So now we got to stand back. It's going to open up our running game.
And
secondly, it's going to be in their mind all the time. Okay, Leotis Palmer can throw the ball now. He's got a 54-yard run. He's got a 55-yard touchdown pass. We got to watch this guy. He's a weapon. We don't know what he's going to do with the football.
Well, the Lobos have been impressive on offense. The last four possessions, with the exception of the interception. We'll see how they answer here. And Kelly calls his own number, gets 2 yards,
focuses on
up near the 26-yard line.
Academics, military training,
and Adam Cole
athletics,
on the stop.
And character development. Cadets graduate with a Bachelor of Science degree and a commission as an Air Force officer.
Very efficient. He's got the one interception, was cost New Mexico a three-point field goal, but been very efficient. 10 of 12. He's been very good in the
Air
intermediate
Force wasting
throw.
Little time
nine
to
so
answer
far
the New Mexico
game.
Touchdown.
They've got the wind to his back.
80 yards in the third plays. And a 55-yard touchdown.
The Air Force defense very tough to beat.
Kelly. And
the
Bears are going to pass thrown by the tailback Palmer. And our first kickoff
through behind Joe Manning
of the game.
And it'll be third down.
Brandon Ratcliffe
finals
now.
It's
Michigan 25. It's the first time anyone's
Ohio
kicked
State
off
at home
into
over
the wind.
Exactly. Let's take a look. This
Navy
touchdown does
North
two
Carolina
things.
State, the Wolfpack,
for Air Force's offense.
A couple of weeks ago, they
first of all, it opens
midship
up your running game now.
17-10 here.
The defensive backs
are going
to be very hesitant from flying up knowing that, hey, wait a minute, they threw a halfback pass on us. So now
we've
got to stand back. It's going to open up our running game. And secondly,
it's
going to be in their mind all the time. Okay, Leotis Palmer can throw the ball now. He's got a 54-yard run. He's got a 55-yard touchdown pass. We've got to watch this guy. He's a weapon. We don't know what he's going to do with the football.
Well, the Lobos have been impressive on offense
an awful long
the last
time,
four possessions,
long,
with the exception of the interception.
And
see how they
Ronnie
answer
Coleman
here.
Wrapped him up.
And Kelly calls his own
when
number.
Air Force
gets
that time came with a stunt.
Up near the 26-yard line.
Off the left side brought two guys. Monty Coleman came
and
free.
Adam Cole
really
on the
a
stop.
Coverage sack. Kelly was looking downfield. His first receiver was covered.
Second
his second receiver
eight
was covered. By that time, Air Force stunt freed up.
Very efficient.
He's got the
Coleman
one interception.
On the outside,
was cost New Mexico
the sack.
A three-point
first
field
time
goal.
We've seen
Kelly with pressure
but,
in his face.
Very efficient.
10 and 12. He's been very good in the intermediate.
Tyler
curls and underneath throws so far in this game.
They've got the wind to his back, so let's see if they try to long that. Big one.
With that zone coverage,
really
the Air Force defense
off
very tough
not
to
a
beat
big
deep.
Kelly takes an Air Force back.
Intermediate pass.
The Falcons will have excellent field position
at the 45-yard line, Joe Manning. And it'll be third down.
11-13 to play in the first half. 35-yard punt. 7.8 for the Falcons.
Navy. Dave McCann, Blaine Fowler, welcome back. Air Force with the ball after the 35-yard punt. It is officially resting at the 44-yard line. Chance Herridge 0 for 3. His tailback has more completions than he does. And Air Force has defended Herridge very well. A deep pitch. And good containment. Joe Schieffer struggles to get back to the line of scrimmage. Nick Spiegel out of Albuquerque in on the stop for the Lobos.
Well, and what happens here, this is what New Mexico can do to you. They can dictate. They bring the safety off the outside, David Hall, on a blitz. He's unaccounted for, and that play designed to go off to the right side because of the blitz. A good guess by Bronco Mendenhall in the booth. Air Force doesn't get to go where they've designed that play to go.
Schieffer just back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10. Herridge at the run all the way. He's across midfield into Lobo territory, and he's close to an Air Force first down.
Herridge with the keeper, run down by the ball.
Might be just a bit short. Charles Moss on the stop. He was 5 of 7 throwing the ball a week ago against Northwestern, but Northwestern had absolutely no idea what was going on the field.
See, what happens with Herridge here, he comes, and when he's got that ball in a throwing position, it really freezes the defense. The linebackers and defensive backs have to stay back until he crosses the line of scrimmage. And you get a look at Bronco Mendenhall, the associate head coach, coordinates this defense. A lot of defenses around the country look at what New Mexico has done and patterned what they're doing after this style of defense. And that time, the defense frozen with Herridge threatening to throw, and that allowed him to find a little seam and turn it up on the run.
We've watched Mendenhall's strategy play out here. It said if Herridge is having a good game, then their strategy is not working. And Herridge has been contained. They figure a quarterback's the best player on the Air Force team. And you mentioned a short while ago, that's why they don't key on the fullback per se, as does everybody else. Leotis Palmer's got to the outside a little bit, but remember, his touchdown run was straight up the middle of that Lobo defense. So defending the perimeter has been excellent again. The rest, what they want to do, Bronco told us, they want to just try and fake Herridge out, not let him know who's blitzing when and where. Yeah, and it's third and one.
They do a great job. They give you a variety of fronts, a variety of blitzes, a lot of man-to-man tight defense in the secondary.
Herridge all the way on third and one. Such a huge hole to the left side of the line. He just followed Brett Heiser and has the first down.
We might mention, as we were looking at that starting offensive line for the Air Force Academy, it's not your typical, you think of small, scrappy linemen as we watch Herridge get up in there. This is a big group for the Academy. 255 is the small cannonball at center, but 295 at left guard, 275 at tackle, 290 at right guard, and 280 at right tackle.
Wyoming, another loss on the road, this time to Central Michigan, 32-20. That a final just moments ago. Here's a bomb from Herridge, and flags fly. Anthony Park, the only one to turn around to look for the ball, and that's maybe where David Crockett was flagged. Crockett, a senior, very experienced in the secondary. We'll check out the replay and find out just what happened. Another long ball attempt, the second long pass thrown by Herridge.
Well, when you see this happen a lot, Crockett's in decent position. Herridge is going to throw this ball up a long way into the wind. It's going to hang on him. So the ball ends up being underthrown. You see Crockett running, and he doesn't know that the ball's underthrown, so he just continues on. He's looking back for the ball, and he ends up running into the receiver. And I wonder about those. Sometimes I think they got an error on the side of the defense on those. When the ball's underthrown, if that defensive back is running and turns back and there's a collision because the ball's underthrown, now I wonder if that call should be made all the time. They make that call. He ran into the receiver, but I'm not sure that's fair to the defense because all he's doing is running in good position, turning back and trying to find the football.
The penalty takes the ball inside the 30 to the 29 and a fresh set of downs for Air Force. And Herridge wants to go back to the air. Screen set up nicely. Tom Heyer Hires got a first down inside the 20. Knocked out at the 17 by Terrell Golden. So Air Force mixing it up with the air a little bit on this drive.
We saw Air Force try to set this screen up a couple series ago, and Herridge floated the ball too high and wasn't able to get it to the screen back. This time he hits higher with a strike. Very well set up. Higher breaks one tackle and gets out, picks up that first down yardage on the sideline for the Falcons.
Big game for Higher. He injured his knee a year ago against the Lobos, missed the rest of the season. He's got the Lobos this year. He's got a first down to the fullback. First big call to the fullback today, and close to another. First down goes Steve Massey, junior out of Fairfax Station, Virginia. Fala Fashola on the stop for his first tackle. But now with the pass completions and the runs by Palmer, here comes the fullback.
Right, and Massey gonna take advantage of the opportunity. The backup last week gets the start because of an injury. Now this is a guy that in a JV game last year from the fullback spot rushed for 300 yards and 5 touchdowns in a game. So he's capable of being explosive from that spot.
Second one, right back to Massey. He's to the 5, enough for a first down. It'll be first and goal Air Force.
It's interesting. You look at the media guides and the bios on these players, and when you read these Air Force bios, these are some smart guys that are admitted into the academy. You look at who they're recruited by, and we're used to doing teams from all around the country, and they're recruited by Tennessee and Florida. Well, Massey was recruited by Georgetown and Brown. You know, you don't get recruited by Georgetown and Brown unless you've got a great academic record, and that's the kind of players that Fisher Deberry has fashioned into a great program here in Colorado Springs.
Time for a big defensive stand by New Mexico. Schieffer gets across the 5, maybe a yard, met by Haybreeze Josie and Charles Voss and company. It'll be second down and goal. Leotis Palmer is back into the game. He's had his hands in on both Air Force touchdowns, a run and a pass. And with Palmer in the game, he's a likely candidate to get the ball. Second and goal from the 4. Herridge wrapped up as he falls forward 3 yards. It'll be third and goal. David Hall and Sidney Wiley wrapping him up.
When you see ice of that time on Leotis Palmer, he's out there having a battle that time. And as a running back in this program, you've got a block. He's out there against Fashola, the Lobo back from New Mexico, having a battle. And I think New Mexico got the better of that one.
Third down and goal from the 3-yard line. Herridge throws back to his tackle. Touchdown! Junior out of Inman, Kansas. And Fisher Deberry, what happened in this running game? A halfback pass and now a throwback to the tackle for a touchdown.
And Newfield, 6'5", 280-pound junior, and really caught New Mexico off guard. You don't account for those tackles, and he was eligible. He was the last man on the line of scrimmage on the left side of the offense. He's an eligible receiver. And actually, when you throw it backward like that, anybody's allowed to catch the ball. Throw it backward to him. It's a lateral. He takes it into the end zone.
Air Force, so they've been watching and waiting for this game all spring and summer. They circled it on the calendar after the beating they took in Albuquerque. They pulled out all the stops so far. 6:51 to play in the first half. Falcons by 14. Twenty-four to 10, Air Force. 56-yard drive, 5 plays, and Newfield, a 5-yard catch from the tackle position. Ball's loose, scoop back up, and this is Brandon Gregory, and he did a whole lot all by himself. Gets the ball out across the 35 to the 36. Pretty good field position for the Lobos. Coming up at halftime, we'll visit with Brett Gilliland of the Mountain West Conference. It's been a good start for the conference as far as battles with BCS schools. And they've got four bowl games to fill at the end of the year, so we'll visit briefly with Brett Gilliland from the conference. Good to have him here at Falcon Stadium. 17-yard return. And now the onus is on New Mexico to strike back. Two consecutive touchdowns for Air Force. Kelly to the air. And he throws it deep into the Falcon bench. And you see Joe Manning with his hands up in the air going, who is that to?
And pressure that time from the backside of Casey Kelly, flushed out of the pocket, trying to throw that ball on a full run.
There is a lot of similarities this year defensively between New Mexico and Air Force, aren't there?
Yeah, Air Force actually looked at New Mexico's defense as one of the models to build their new defensive philosophy. They also looked at the Pittsburgh Steelers and basically came up with a mixture, but it stems from a lot of the same things that Bronco Mendenhall has done at New Mexico.
Right. Just looking for a hole and doesn't find much at all. And Anthony Slego lead way on the tackle along with Coleman.
Watches Air Force Academy plays down the line of scrimmage, and Schlegel and Coleman both did a good job of playing off blocks. They got their hands out in front, didn't allow the blockers to get to their legs, pushed the blockers down into the ground and came off of those blocks to make tackles. A perfect linebacker play by Schlegel, and a good play by a defensive end to come down the line by Coleman.
Third and 10, screen play, broken up, intended for Wright. But that wasn't going to happen from the onset because Air Force had it well defended. And a fourth down coming up for New Mexico. Another chance for Tyler Goss to kick with the wind behind him. But it's always trouble when you kick against Air Force. They blocked the punt last week for a touchdown. They blocked 96 since 1990. One of the best punt blocking teams in college football. And they appear to be ready to come here. Goss is a freshman out of San Diego. Martin Lovato with the snap. Gets it away, and it's nicely done at the 20. And going backwards, Palmer. Good coverage by New Mexico. Earlier, we caught up with New Mexico head coach Rocky Long to get his perspective on this early conference battle.
The team that wins that game is going to have a big boost because we're going to be first place in the conference for probably 3 or 4 weeks before the conference season actually kicks off, and that's a good kick in the pants. But it's so early in the season. It'll be our third game, and I think it'll be their second game. It's so early in the season, if you put too much emphasis on that game and you lost that game, it could ruin the rest of your season.
45-yard punt. Good look at Rocky Long. Fifth year as head coach at New Mexico, 19 wins, 29 losses. He's 11-18 in the conference. But he's 3-0 in his last three against Air Force. And this will back the Falcons up five more yards. Brett Waller jumped the gun. It'll be first and 15. But you know, Blaine, that...
Dead ball. Full start. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still. First down.
Rocky Long a bit nervous here because he knows Air Force is very capable of keeping the football for a great deal of time, and teams that fall behind too much against them have an awful time getting the ball back, enough to get back in the game. Leotis Palmer darts across the 25, gets the penalty yardage back and much more, and it'll be second down and about four, so 11 yards for Palmer. And Moss on the stop for the Lobos.
When we've seen Leotis Palmer much more involved in the offense this week than he was last week against Northwestern. And we expected that. Everything went so easy for the Air Force with big plays and easy scores against Northwestern that Palmer only got 7 rushes in the entire game. Here in this game, he already has 7 rushes for 80 yards, and he's also thrown a touchdown pass.
Back to the fullback. Ball nearly came loose. There was a wrestling match. Right after the handoff, maybe a yard. Guillermo Morrison on the stop for the Lobos, and it'll be third down and about three. The Sports West College football presentation is brought to you in part by Delta. Everyone has a reason to see somebody person to person. That's the reason Delta flies. 4:30 and ticking away here. 24-10 Air Force, second quarter. Third and three, it's Schieffer. Schieffer's in all kinds of trouble. Lobos needed a big stop, and that's exactly what they got. And Air Force is going to have to kick it away into the wind. Radcliffe and Spiegel making sure Schieffer goes down. And on four, they lost about 2 yards, almost fourth and five. Air Force will kick it away.
Very well defended that time. Brandon Radcliffe, the Lobo back for New Mexico, he's a real interesting story. He sat out all of 2001 with an academic problem. He was eligible by NCAA standards, but New Mexico has a higher standard for their athletes than does the NCAA, which I think is great. He sat out, so he has been very hungry to get back on the field.
Blocked! The Lobos have it! Inside the 10-yard line to the six. Air Force may have jumped on the loose ball, but it's a big block kick. There's a flag down right in front of the Lobo bench, but Brandon Gregory flew in and blocked the punt. Air Force is used to blocking punts, not having their kicks blocked, but the field judge is standing right over the flag. The Lobo players are signaling that it is against Air Force, and if it is, what a play on special teams for the Lobos.
Legal formation. Kicking team, not enough men on the line. Penalties declined. First down, New Mexico.
So a huge play for New Mexico. Get them right back in this game. They come up with a good defensive series, and then the big block. And New Mexico's in business here. We just talked about not getting behind Air Force because they're so good at controlling the football. And Rocky Long's got to be not too much excitement in his face right there. I mean, that wasn't much of a reaction at all. It was like, yeah, I expected that. That was good.
Brandon Gregory, the senior out of St. Louis, with the block punt. And it's first and goal from the six for the Lobos. And right. Fisher Deberry seething on the sidelines. And they set the play. First and goal from the six after the block punt. Kelly to Wright. And Wright's wrapped up. Got to the five, maybe a couple inches further. But no more. Marcello Grotti on the stop.
Well, you remember, take you back to the first quarter when New Mexico threw the interception. New Mexico's defense came up big and held Air Force to only a field goal. Now here, Air Force defense in the same situation. The punting team gave up a big play. If they can come away with holding New Mexico to a field goal, it'd be a major victory for this Air Force defense.
Second and goal. Back to right, straight ahead. Wrapped up again. Got a little bit closer. And it'll be third down and goal for New Mexico. Quincy Wright is putting in the hours on the job today, but Joe Bielo and Nicholas Taylor there to knock him down. What do you do here, Blaine? You throw it or you go back to Wright?
I think you need to get the quarterback out on the perimeter with a play run option where you can put some pressure on that secondary to have to cover. Get him out there on the corner and let him make a decision.
Third and goal, New Mexico. Counter in motion. Kelly, quarterback draw. Touchdown!
Before you run a quarterback draw, you fake the handoff to the motion man and come back inside and get up in behind those big hogs on the front line.
Second touchdown of the first half for Casey Kelly. So an enormous block punt cashed in for a touchdown.
Well, and look at the block that time. He gets right up in behind Claude Terrell that time. The big 330-pound sophomore And well, if you get behind him, nobody can see you. Then he slides off in for the touchdown.
Zucker, the extra point. It was a knuckleball, but it was just high enough. And with 1:57 to play in the first half, New Mexico is back within 7, 24-17.
Let's take a look at that again. Watch big number 76 working his guy, a 330-pounder. And Casey Kelly knows where to go. Just get up in behind big number 76, and he'll take you into the end zone.
So a bit of a surprise. Leotis Palmer with a long touchdown pass. The right tackle for Air Force, Blaine Newfield, with a short touchdown catch. Didn't figure that. Figured Herridge would have his hand in on many of those. And for New Mexico, it's not right. It's not counter. It's not. It's Casey Kelly running in two touchdowns. As we look at the advantage, rent-a-car scoring drive, 3 plays, 6 yards. Took him 1:31. And Kelly, from 4 yards out on 3rd and goal, gets into the end zone. That's one of the great things about college football, is there is a plan of attack and expectations, and it all changes when you kick off. Another deep kick into the end zone. Blue will put a knee down, and the Falcons will go at it from the 20. We'll keep it right here with 1:57 to play here in the first half. Next week, the Lobos are home to take on the Baylor Bears, and Air Force has the week off to prepare for road trips to California. And then later this month, what an enormous matchup Air Force has in Salt Lake City against the Utes. A lot of folks figure Utah to be the preseason favorite in the conference. However, Colorado State has looked awfully good, and BYU is going to be tough to beat as well. And these two teams don't go down easy either. We'll see what kind of approach the Falcons take. It is the hurry-up. Give to the fullback for 3 yards over the right side into the arms of DJ Renteria out of Roswell High School. A couple products there. New Mexico products on this football team out of Roswell High School. Second down, and the clock ticks away.
It doesn't look like... Air Force is in any rush to do a two-minute offense to try to put the ball up in the air. They've got that 7-point lead. They've shown an awful lot of offense here in the early going in this game.
They'll get the ball to start the third quarter. This is Herridge. Late pitch to Palmer. First down and a late hit coming. There are the flags. That's going to put 15 more yards onto that, and suddenly Air Force with a chance to threaten.
When you watch Chance Herridge that time, keep that football to the very last minute, get the defense to commit, and pitch it out to Leotis Palmer. And Air Force's philosophy on the pitch back is really interesting. They don't want that ball pitched backward. They actually want it directly sideways, and you saw Palmer in the perfect position to get positive yards on the pitch, and then the hit out of bounds, which is going to carry another 15 yards tacked on to the end of that.
81 yards for Leotis Palmer. 54 on a touchdown run early in the game. The ball's now out to the 47-yard line with 1:15 to go. So let's see if the penalty changes the approach. Herridge back to throw. He's got Palmer. Incomplete. Palmer trying to beat Ratcliffe.
And flags all over the backfield that time.
Holding against Air Force.
You know, one thing for Air Force, when Air Force throws in the context of their normal offense, it's very tough to defend them because you're playing mostly man-to-man defense. You're coming up defending the run, and so they catch you by surprise.
Holding. Offense. 10-yard penalty. Repeat. First down.
But when you're playing them in a situation like this, and you can see the hold on the backside, watch right here as Herridge rolls out to his right. Well,
Massey will tackle there.
If you're going to miss your block, you don't want your quarterback to get hit. Just tackle the guy, and Massey did that time. But my thought on defense, when it's two-minute offense and you're expecting throw, it's a little easier to defend what Air Force is trying to do in the air.
So the penalty takes the ball back to the 38. And with 1:10 to play. A little delay handoff. Not much there. Schieffer with no success running the ball. And Fashola wrapped him up and threw him down. And now New Mexico is called for a timeout. And they have visions of getting the ball back, or at least sending the Air Force punter back out there, where the last time out he was blocked, and the psyche can do amazing things. So a minute one to play on the scoreboard, and a timeout called.
Well, and even if they don't get the block, he would be punting into a pretty stiff wind coming out of the south, and may set up a decent return for the Lobos. We mentioned earlier, in the previous 2 years, New Mexico's had a bye week before the Air Force game, which is really advantageous when you're playing this option. You don't see the option very often, and they've had that this year. No bye, coming right off of two straight games. Really only 3 days of preparation to get ready for this, you know, full preparation. Yet, even with that, New Mexico's played pretty well defensively. Air Force has thrown a lot of offense at New Mexico here in this first half. We've seen that playbook open that wide open by Chuck Peterson here in the first half for the Falcons.
See the timeouts. Ball's on the 40. It's second and 17. Fisher Deberry told us they need to avoid second and 17s without question. And Herridge struggling to get back to the line of scrimmage again, and again a timeout, and now a late flag comes in from the far side of the field. What was a very exciting second quarter has really come to a sluggish stop here in the waning moments. And here comes Ken Rivera.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, offense, 15-yard penalty, third down.
Air Force is going the wrong way. Fisher Deberry. He doesn't like penalties to begin with, especially these kind.
When Rocky Long still has a timeout left, and now Air Force is in third and long, he can use that timeout and force Air Force to punt the football. 55 seconds left, and New Mexico is going to get the ball back unless Air Force comes up with a great play for third and 32 to get a first down. But not a lot of plays in your playbook for third and 32.
And the wind is howling here at the stadium, and that's one thing Rocky Long is looking at. He wants to see an Air Force punt into the breeze, and that is the goalpost actually moving around. So the ball is back to the 25, and the Air Force punter will be kicking into the face of that wind. It is third and 32. Sports West is your source for sports on the internet. For the latest information on your local team schedules and upcoming telecasts, go online with Sports West at www.gosportswest.com. We have a very busy fall ahead. A lot of great games in the Mountain West Conference. This is the first of them. So on third down and 32 with 55 seconds to play in the half, Air Force will go to work. Quarterback draw. And Herridge is wrapped up. Had some room if he could have got around to the outside, but he could not get around the Lobos' Nick Spiegel. And another timeout. So with 47 seconds to play, the punting unit will come on. And New Mexico should get a great chance and even a field goal before halftime.
Boy, and it's amazing how things changed just in one series. Air Force started out the series, they were just going to try to kill the clock, and then they had a big play and so decided to go a little hurry up and try to score themselves. And then penalties and some big plays by New Mexico set them back, and then New Mexico's thinking, hey, wait a minute, now we want to stop the clock and get the ball back, and they certainly will here. With 46 seconds left, they'll have one more chance to get their hands on that football in this half and try to maneuver down into field goal range, and they've got a big wind at their back, so a long field goal is not out of the question.
And the initial penalty in this drive was the 15-yarder against the Lobos. Air Force had the ball first and 10, at the 45-yard line. Then the momentum shift with penalties and good defensive play. And now John Welsh is at his 10-yard line. The last time his punt was blocked. And counter is waiting at the 35 with big intentions. Now the return is set up. It's a short kick. Takes a New Mexico bounce, a very short kick, and the Lobos will have the ball on the Air Force 47 with 39 seconds to play in the half. Plenty of time to do something. A 22-yard punt right into the teeth of that wind, and you saw that wind just throw the ball back down to the grass.
Boy, and you get two things going through your mind as a punter back there. You're thinking, okay, the last one got blocked. I've got to hurry. And not only do I have to hurry, I'm punting into a stiff wind, and so a mental... you have to have mental toughness to just go ahead and punt it. That one kind of came off the side of the foot and got knocked down by the wind real quick.
No timeouts for New Mexico. Air Force has three. And Kelly to go to work from the shotgun. Screen pass to Wright with a lot of room. And Wright. How about this run? Quincy Wright. One of the truly great runs of this young season anywhere in college football. Quincy Wright and the Lobos are an extra point away from tying the game.
Well, and once Wright got out in the open on that little dump pass, a little quick screen to the right, you knew that he was going to score. He just outruns everybody to the corner of the end zone with his great speed. And a good call on first down by New Mexico. They knew they could stop the clock with first downs and threw it, not afraid to throw it in the inside of the field.
Zunker for the tie. 24-all. A couple of quick strikes by the Lobos, and the game has been changed.
Watch this. Just slide Quincy Wright out for a screen. Just tell Wright, you got to either get a first down or get out of bounds. Once he has the first down, he's free to go wherever he wants. Now watch his speed as he just runs right past everyone on the field using that 10, 500-meter speed to get to the end zone. What a weapon Quincy Wright is for these Lobos. Everybody looks like they're standing still when he's running out there.
They're just watching him go, and it's been an amazing twist because New Mexico has seemed to neutralize Air Force, and they go into the half, what looks like to be all tied up, so it's been neutralized on the scoreboard, and Wright has proved to be an awfully tough back to bring down, and we're going to see a whole lot of him in the second half.
And I'll tell you who's having a good game for New Mexico is Claude Terrell, their offensive right guard. He was out in front, made three blocks downfield on that play. And we've talked about him a lot. He's been instrumental in a lot of the running game for New Mexico. He's having a heck of a game at right guard for New Mexico.
Zunker, this one just might be returned. Blue, won't do it. It's the knee down. And Air Force will have one more possession before the half expires with 23 seconds left to play. 12 rushes, 91 yards. One reception, 48 yards for a touchdown. Not a bad half against a pretty good defense. This is a defense that paralyzed Northwestern a week ago. And Quincy Wright has come in and he has wowed this crowd. And Herridge is going to put a knee down. And we're going to clear the field. Wow, what a finish in the second quarter. The Lobos come storming back. And halftime has arrived at Falcon Stadium. We're pretty much right where we were when we started. All tied up. New Mexico 24, Air Force 24. Hey, what should we expect? This is the first Mountain West Conference battle of the season. Homecoming festivities continuing at Falcon Stadium. We're at the half, and look at that score. New Mexico 24, Air Force 24. Dave McCann, Blaine Fowler. And it's nice to have you with us on this first Saturday here in September. And as we talked about before kickoff, this game means so much to these two teams.
Well, it does. And you can see the emotions running high on both sides of the football. And New Mexico getting a huge boost right before halftime. They seemed a little down. Air Force was going to be content to run out the clock, and they were not successful in doing that. New Mexico takes a big momentum boost into the locker room here at halftime.
We've seen some amazing plays, very unpredictable plays. The halfback pass from Leotis Palmer to Ricky Amezaga for a touchdown, and then the pass back to the right tackle from Chance Herridge to Blaine Newfield for a touchdown from the New Mexico end. We've seen some solid defensive play like we expected, but some amazing runs by Quincy Wright.
Well, he's been all that was expected. And played against Weber State and had a big game. Was very solid against North Carolina State. Only ran the ball 11 times in that game for 65 yards, but his average was solid. And the big question was, okay, what will he do against a solid defense in conference? Air Force is a solid defensive football team. It's not Weber State. Well, he's looked just as good. He looks just as quick against the Air Force Falcons as he did against Weber State last week.
If you're an Air Force fan, you're wondering, I think, all your tricks are used up. You only have a few, and they all work for touchdowns. And so now you think about lining up against this New Mexico team in the second half with no advantage on the scoreboard. If you're Lobo fans, you got to like that because, hey, they've tried everything and stuff. Now we're back to the basics of power football, and they can't run on the Lobo defense.
Well, and both teams have ridden the hill of emotion on both sides here in the first half. You start all over again. The teams have a feel for each other now. It's going to be much more difficult for Air Force to move the ball in the second half.
It's been a BCS kind of start to the season for the Mountain West. We'll visit with Brett Gilliland from the conference when we come back. It's halftime here, tied up at 24. You're watching college football on Sports West, and we're back after a message from your local station. Cadet band on the field as halftime plays on, all tied up at 24 apiece. Blaine Fowler, you had a couple of minutes to think about things. Biggest thought to the first half?
Well, I thought it was an explosive first half. I thought we saw a lot of things. I thought we saw most of Air Force's playbook. I think Chuck Peterson pulled everything out of there in the first half with good success, but New Mexico still in the football game with some big plays of their own.
New Mexico's beaten the Falcons 3 years straight, and they've shown in that first half, take away a couple of the trick plays, they still know how to defend the triple option.
Well, they do, and they had a big play on a punt block there. They really played well and didn't allow themselves to get out of the game and get behind by too much. We talked about that in the first half. If you get trailing the Air Force Academy, they're so good at possessing the ball and taking time off that clock. New Mexico could not afford to do that. Rocky Long kept his players up, and they stayed in the game, and they go in at halftime with a big boost.
The block punt changed everything and fired the Lobos up, and back they came with a couple of touchdowns. Let's look at the numbers from the first half. They're the Sinclair first half statistics. Wherever you travel, look for the big green dinosaur, the sign of quality gasoline and oil products, Sinclair. Blaine?
Well, New Mexico effectively throwing the ball. Casey Kelly's been good with the intermediate stuff. He's been, in the first quarter, he went underneath to Dwight Counter and Manning, and then came back. A lot of that 224 yards coming on the big screen pass at the end of the half that got them back in the football game and tied up. The one turnover resulted in only a field goal for the Air Force Academy, which was big for the New Mexico defense. For Air Force, 119 yards rushing, 70 passing yards on a halfback pass pretty much, and the pass back to the tackle, so on some trick plays. This is going to be a great second half of football here in Colorado Springs.
Time of possession, a big concern for Fisher Deberry. Last year in the second half against the Lobos, Air Force got only 14 plays on offense. Well, we've got plenty of highlights to check out, some amazing stuff, and we'll do just that when we come back after this word from your local station. Halftime at Falcon Stadium, New Mexico 24, Air Force 24. Let's dive right into the first half highlights. We have a lot to show, and we're surprised right off the bat with Leotis Palmer from Air Force. Who thought he'd go 54 yards right through the heart of the Lobo defense?
Boy, he started inside, bounced it to the right side, and used his tremendous speed, breaking one tackle to go all the way down the sideline, 54 yards to open the scoring for the Academy.
Palmer can run. Well, he can also pass. How about this one to Ricky Amezaga all the way for a touchdown, really surprising the Lobos.
When the Air Force reached deep into their playbook, Chance Herridge on a screen back to the big offensive tackle, Blaine Newfield, who gets in the end zone for a touchdown, an offensive lineman's dream.
For the New Mexico Lobos, Casey Kelly, pretty good numbers in the first half, finds Joe Manning. That takes him to the goal line, and Kelly jumps over. He scored a couple of touchdowns. Here's the big play by Brandon Gregory.
Now this blocked punt led directly to a New Mexico touchdown and really changed the momentum in that first half.
This by Kelly gets the Lobos within seven. And then after a punt, how about this play?
Right, at the end of the game, Air Force just trying to run the clock out. New Mexico got it back with under 50 seconds to go. 48 yards on the screen pass. And Quincy Wright shows you his outstanding speed as he beats everyone into the left corner of the end zone.
So that's the first half. What is in store for the second half? We'll find out coming up. 24 all as we get set for the start of the second half. The Falcons will receive. They won the toss at the start of the game and deferred for this very purpose, to get the ball first after an opportunity to make adjustments at halftime. Here are the numbers as we compare the signal callers playing.
Right, Kelly very efficient in the first half. He had the one interception, which was the only blemish on what he did in the first half. And credit should go to that New Mexico offensive line. They've done a very good job of protecting Kelly when he's wanted to throw the football. For Herridge, 2 of 5, really not much throwing game in the first half. Air Force hasn't had to throw the ball much. They've had big plays and have been able to score in that way.
Herridge rushed for 94 yards last week against Northwestern. Well, we won't need him today, but later in the year, they'll be glad to have him. Brand new permanent lights put in at Falcon Stadium. They'll be cranked on for sure for their first night game against Notre Dame. Last week in Las Vegas, look what happened. I was there at this game. The power went out with 7:41 to go between UNLV and Wisconsin. After about 25 minutes, they got the backup generators on. Not enough light to play the game. Coaches got together. They said, that's it. Let's just call it. So the game was stopped. And Wisconsin won 27-7. It was quite a scene down on the field.
Game's over.
Nevada Power said, hey, we had an equipment failure at a little riser about a mile and a half away from Sam Boyd Stadium. And the error was corrected. Power restored early Sunday morning. They're hoping it is, because UNLV plays under the lights tonight against Kansas, and both of these teams will play at UNLV later in the year, and those will be late in the game, late in the day type games when the lights will be on. But Falcon Stadium, they're happy to be able to turn the switch and light this place up. Second half kickoff is presented by your local Lexus dealers, who invite you to test drive a Lexus today. And we're underway, and that wind has not stopped, and Blue is driven back into the end zone. So there will be no return. Very rare to have a kick return here in this football game. So Air Force will go from the 20-yard line. So, Blaine, you're the coach. What adjustments did you make on offense if you're Fisher Deberry?
Well, offensively, they did a lot of trick play. I do think that Chuck Peterson offensively has some more things in store. They have a multiple offense. I think that Air Force needs to get to what they do best, and that is run the option with Chance Herridge. And I think you'll see a lot of that here in the first part of this third quarter.
That's Palmer in motion. Herridge with the ball. Across the 30 and a first down run. Herridge's longest run of the game. Billy Struther pulled him down. And Leotis Palmer, big factor, had his hands in on a couple of touchdowns there in the first half. One on the ground and then he threw a pass. Leotis Palmer figures to play a significant role in this second half for the Falcons. Already over 100 yards on the ground. New Mexico doesn't give up too many 100-yard games to anybody. Now Herridge, he ran the right side, going to try the left. Takes a big hit, but not before he picks up 3 yards to make it 2nd and 7.
One of the things as we've covered Air Force over the years that's impressed me is the way the backs block for one another. They're the best cut blocking team in the country. And if you're going to play running back, either one of the wing backs or a fullback here at the Air Force Academy, you are expected to block. And Steve Massey was out in front on that one, throwing a cut block on Charles Moss to try to spring Chance Herridge.
2nd and 7 from the 34. Leotis Palmer makes his way for a few more and will set up 3rd down and 3. Fisher Deberry said some interesting things about his quarterback. He says, you know, what makes him nervous about Herridge is Herridge would just as soon run into you as run around you. And when you're the signal caller at Air Force and there's not a whole lot behind you, you got to stay healthy.
Boy, they really worry because he has that mentality. He's got linebacker's mentality. He says if he's running down the sideline, there was somebody in the middle of the field, he'd veer over in the middle and try to run over the guy.
Third and about 2.5. Herridge to Palmer. You see how fast New Mexico is cutting down the perimeter. Palmer gets very close to the first down. Billy Strother, the speed, 230-pound linebacker over there to make the stop, and they're going to measure this one, going to be very close. What looks like a big play is controlled in just a matter of seconds by the speed of New Mexico's linebackers.
And that is the strength of this New Mexico defense. Charles Moss in the middle. We haven't called his name a lot, and I'm surprised because I thought he'd be very active in this game.
That's how close. Nose of the football. First down. Look at our Applebee's scores. Oklahoma up early on Alabama. A surprise here. Fresno State and Oregon tied up at 7 first. And no score between Washington and San Jose in the second. Keep your eye on our Applebee's scoreboard throughout the afternoon and keep up to speed on games being played around the country. First and 10, Air Force. Another dive into the line on the counter. And Don Clark with the carry. David Hall on the stop. Well, if we were anticipating Air Force really in a big hurry to get on the board, that is not the case here in the early minutes of the third quarter. A lot of dives inside and pitches around both sides of the line. Clock on the move. Now a pass from Herridge. Threw into trouble. Is almost picked off, and then an amazing catch by James Waller. Herridge kind of put that one up for grabs, and Waller grabbed it away.
Boy, an Air Force expecting to just have man coverage, and you had man coverage, but on the opposite side of the ball, New Mexico is dropping back. A chance Herridge didn't see the defenders there, just tried to touch it in there, and boy, very fortunate that his own receiver came up with it on that one. What a great catch by Waller.
Billy Strother thought for sure he had an interception. Massey, the fullback, inside the 40 to the 39, another 4 yards up the middle. And it'll be second down and about 6. Running behind that line of Waller, Heiser, Southam, under Bakke and Neufeld. Let's talk about the center, Wayne Southam out of Aurora, Colorado. He is the cannonball champion. How do you become the cannonball champion?
He's the world champion.
Not just the champion.
He's the world cannonball champion. I guess down in Denver, or up in Denver, they have a cannonball championship every year. He went up and entered. He's got the perfect body for it at 6'2 and 255 pounds. And Coach Deberry said he's the world's cannonball champion. He knows how to perfectly get round and get into the water and cause the biggest splash. I mean, that's a title you always strive for as a kid, to be the world cannonball champ.
And he won like $500 in the NCAA. Let him keep it. As you're the cannonball champion, you keep the prize. Air Force has called timeout to avoid a penalty. When we come back, they'll have 2nd and 6 from the 39, all tied up. After the timeout, it is 2nd down and 6, Air Force on the New Mexico 39-yard line. Early stages of the third quarter. And Chance Herridge changing the play after the timeout. He may have to take another one. Play clock winding down. They just did get it off, and Herridge is in trouble. Ball's loose. Lobos have it. DJ Renteria scoops up the fumble. Terrell Golden knocked it free, and he had a clear open shot on the quarterback, and he laid Herridge out big time.
and Golden from his safety spot come from the backside, and he was right up on the line of scrimmage like he was going to blitz to start, and it looked as if Herridge saw that and made the audible because of the blitz, but totally unaware of Golden coming from the backside. Big play by Golden, used his speed to get past the outside blocking, get their former walk-on, Golden, honorable mention all-conference last year, and he gives his team a big opportunity here in the third quarter.
Here come the Lobos. They've scored 14 unanswered points, and Quincy Wright struggles for two, gets right to the heart of the field at the 50. Trevor Hightower on the stop for Air Force. First turnover of the entire season for Air Force. We say entire, it's their second game, but they ran so many plays last week against Northwestern, and the ball's been all over the place in the first half, but that there, their first turnover.
We looked at those total offense numbers, almost exactly even, 24-24. And Rocky Long said before this game, I feel like the teams are very evenly matched in terms of physical abilities, and he was right.
Kelly running the option to Wright, and Wright tripped up and stopped by Wes Qualley. And it looked like before that play that Kelly was signaling to his receiver, you got this block, right? And they ran the option, and there was the block wasn't there, and Wright was cut down. It'll be third down and six.
Well, Crawley played it perfectly. Played outside in. He played off of the block and made the tackle. Wes Crawley's already been selected for the East-West Shrine game this year. So before the season started, he'd been elected to play in that football game, which is a great honor. 55 tackles last year and 3 interceptions.
Air Force had a third and six. Got hit and fumbled. Now it's third and six for the Lobos. The Falcons bring pressure. Kelly delivers, but it's incomplete. And it looked like Joe Manning got a couple of hands on that ball. Mark Marsh was in the area to get in the way, and New Mexico is going to have to kick it away.
When you look at the play selection, New Mexico 21 rushes and 38 passes. Air Force 32 rushes. And so pretty much balance on both sides. And that time, Casey Kelly did everything that he was supposed to do in the blitz situation. He got rid of the football. He got it where it needed to be. Manning just not coming up with a catch for his quarterback.
Low snap for Goss, but he recovers nicely and kicks it high inside the five and rolls into the end zone. So Air Force again will start from the 20. 9:46 to play here in the third quarter. 52-yard punt. And the game is tied at 24. Welcome back, and there may not be another team in the Mountain West Conference that travels better than New Mexico. And a whole lot of them are here today, along with the band, and they're enjoying a pretty good football game. On first down, it's Steve Massey, the fullback, getting his biggest run of the day. Out to the 35, Fashola on the stop for the Lobos. Throughout the ball game today, watch for the Applebee's score updates. Applebee's neighborhood restaurants invite you to try all of your Applebee's favorites to go. It's not fast food, it's Applebee's food fast. 35-yard lines, score updates. In the corner there, boy, that Miami-Florida game just getting underway. What a big game that is for college football today. We've got a tie at 24, second offensive possession for Air Force here in the second half. And New Mexico is just all over the triple option. And Fashola's having a spectacular afternoon on defense. Loss of yardage. It'll be second and 13. Leotis Palmer just engulfed by Fashola.
When the key is they force Herridge to give up the ball early. Watch as they come down. They contain the quarterback. That's Charles Moss. I mentioned him last series, and we haven't called his name much. He's responsible for the quarterback on that. He gets to the quarterback quickly, forces Herridge to give the ball up, and Fashola's there on the pitch, man. Perfectly covered option that time by the New Mexico defense.
Second and 13 now. Lobos threaten another blitz. Here they come. Herridge, pretty good fake. Dives up close to the 40. Cut down just past the 39. And gave you a Fulbright stop, redshirt freshman. Got a lot of youth in this New Mexico defense. And Rocky Long had told us earlier in the week that he was nervous about this game because he's got secondary guys that have never seen the triple option. But Air Force has not been able to hurt them on the perimeter where that's so dangerous.
And New Mexico's done a very good job. Air Force has beaten New Mexico on some big plays, but haven't had a lot of long, you know, drives where they manipulate the clock like they normally do.
Herridge fits for the first down. Anthony Butler, and that's Anthony Butler's first carry of the game. You know, check that, that's Darnell Stevens, his first carry of the game.
And as we say, Air Force hasn't had one of their methodical drives that are traditional Air Force. They're in the midst of one right here, looking very good, running a variety of their base offense. Counters and quick traps inside have mixed in with their option game on the outside. They're looking pretty good on this drive.
Anthony Butler strained his shoulder last week against Northwestern, the other halfback in this group, and he was questionable for this afternoon, and we have not seen him carry the ball. First down, Air Force on the 48-yard line. And it's another look. This time not as successful, but still quite a run by Stevens. He got 2 yards, took about 9 hits getting it. And Guillermo Morrison credited with bringing him down.
Boy, and Darnell Stevens made this play by himself just to get back to the line of scrimmage. This should have been a 10-yard loss. Was played very well on the outside by who else? Fashola, who's been in on every tackle, it seems like, for New Mexico. He played off the block and played it well. Should have been a 7-yard loss. An individual effort that time by Darnell Stevens. He broke 3 or 4 tackles and got back for a positive gain of just a couple.
Second down and 8. This third quarter just fading away quickly. Nearing the 6:30 mark. Herridge, quarterback draw. Dodges one Lobo. Gets hit by 3 others, but not before a pickup of about 7. There'll be another 3rd and short. Sidney Wiley pulling him down.
When Fisher Deberry describes Chance Herridge as a street fighter. He's a battler. Watch the move here on the inside. He puts on Charles Moss. A little juke to the right. Usually just likes to run over guys, but Charles Moss isn't the guy you want to run into. Gets positive yards for his team. Wants to be a coach when it's all done. Herridge says he'd like to coach right here at the Air Force Academy.
Massey, the fullback. If he got it, it would be just barely, but I don't know if he got back to the line of scrimmage. Charles Moss on the stop. The Lobos are signaling that they want the football, but none of the officials will have that, and they're going to have to measure. Our officiating crew, Ken Rivera, Al Corey, Mark Ratner, Randy Campbell, Greg Wilson, Scott Novak, and Craig Battaglia. Pretty good crew here today. Fourth down, they're not even going to measure. Fourth and a full yard, and Air Force will go for it. And the cadets are up off their seats. Palmer in motion, Herridge to his fullback.
Well, I think Massey got it, but it was just pure strength. There was not much of a hole there, as New Mexico was very stout defensively, but where they've marked it, looks like he'll have it by about a 0.5 yard.
They're signaling for the chains to come in, or if they did, it won't be by much. Moss on the stop.
And here at the Air Force, they use the quick stick. They don't even use chains anymore. We're so used to calling it chains. And he's got it by, you have to be past that little rubber nubbin that's behind the football.
Wow.
So they got it by a full football.
A new set of downs for Air Force. And they went to the fullback, Steve Massey, trying to use all 230 pounds of it.
That quick stick, it's a great idea. It's as accurate as chains, and the good part about the quick stick is there's only one thing on the sideline for the players to run into, one appliance over there, if you want to call it that. So instead of having a whole set of chains over there.
First and 10, Air Force at the 41. Palmer with the ball. He's thrown it before. He'll throw it again to Herridge. Complete first down. Leonis Palmer is 2 for 2 throwing the football. Nick Spiegel landed on Herridge, and that almost went the distance.
I'm telling you, this is a heck of a throw by Leotis Palmer, because Herridge was covered pretty well. Nick Spiegel read this all the way. He went outside. Palmer threw it up the field, and look at a great throw by a running back and one heck of a catch by a quarterback on pretty good coverage by Nick Spiegel on the play. New Mexico was not completely fooled on that one, but the execution was perfect by Palmer and Herridge.
First reception by Herridge as an Air Force Falcon. They're spreading it around. Under 4.5 to play in the third. Now it's Herridge to the air. Dodgers one, he's got a whole lot of room. Takes it out of bounds near the 20-yard line. And a pickup of about 7, chased out by Spiegel and Crockett. Well, maybe not as many as 7, maybe a good 6. It'll be 2nd and 4.5, and those aren't bad numbers.
Boy, passing efficiency, he's leading the country right now. Not enough attempts to qualify, but 2 for 2 for 70 yards and 1 touchdown, no interceptions.
Well, we have the fourth quarter still ahead of us.
He's on fire.
he might throw a few more. 2nd down, about 4.5. We'll call it 5 on the graphic. Fullback, Massey, lowers his head, leans forward. Not for much. Stop shy of the 17, closer to the 18. DJ Renteria, right in on the stop for Rocky Longs Lobos.
When Renteria, he is low there in the interior of that line. He's a 6'3", 274-pounder. Staff says he's the best athlete on that defensive line, and he squats 650 pounds. I mean, if you put 650 on my shoulders and then let go of it, it would just crush me down into dust on the ground. He'll squat down to 90 degrees and back up with that.
Herridge to Clark. Clark with some room and a blocker out front. He's inside the 10. Another first down. It'll be 1st and goal Air Force at about the 9. Wiley knocking him out of bounds. And the drive continues. And keep in mind, Air Force is driving into the wind. In the fourth quarter, the wind will be to their back, and New Mexico will have a great disadvantage if and when they've got a kick or
right.
Throw deep.
Well, and we were saying earlier that maybe Chuck Peterson has used up his entire playbook, but we were wrong on that. Air Force still continues to bring all kinds of razzle-dazzle to the plays. When you think of Air Force, you think of a rushing team. They're always in the top 2 or 3 in the country in rushing at the end of the season. But they're not a boring 3 yards in a cloud of dust type rushing team like you associate with the Big Ten. These guys do a lot of things offensively.
Massey, the fullback, inside the 5, down to the 3. Moss on the stop. A week ago, Air Force rushed the ball for 476 yards against Northwestern. They lead the country coming into this game on the ground. And they started this triple option in 1981, the year after Fisher Deberry came on board as an assistant. And then Deberry took over in 84. And, boy, the rest is history.
And he coached the quarterbacks and ran that offense. And one of the great option attacks. In fact, nobody runs it better. There are some teams that may have better athletes that run the option, but nobody runs the pure option better than the Air Force Academy.
Massey to the goal line. And there's no call. It'll be 3rd down and inches. Moss again and Wiley on the stop, trying to keep the big fella from pulling across the goal line.
I've often thought, what if a team like Nebraska, with the athletes they have and the speed that they have, could execute the option as well as the Air Force Academy? They'd be unstoppable.
3rd down and 1. Air Force trying to retake the lead after 2 unanswered New Mexico touchdowns. Herridge is our number touchdown. Third rushing touchdown of the year for Chance Herridge. And with 2:04 to play in the third, Air Force has retaken the lead 30-24.
Take a look at the surge of that front. Chance Herridge, if you're going to have a quarterback that's going to get in on the sneak, he's got that mentality to get low and root it into the end zone.
Ashcroft. We mentioned earlier his famous uncle, the Attorney General John Ashcroft, became part of his life and stayed a close part of his life when Joey was a teenager. Went through some trouble at home, the loss of his father, and his uncle was there, and now his uncle's one of the most powerful men in America. But Joey Ashcroft kicks Air Force to a 7-point lead. Play drive, 80 yards, 7:42, a 1-yard run. Vintage Air Force on that drive, and Greenaway into the wind, kicks it out of the end zone. So no return for Tony Frazier.
Well, that wind hasn't let up, so that was a heck of a kick by Greenaway. Now, every time Air Force has surged in this game, New Mexico has had an answer. Look at that time of possession in the third quarter. Air Force came out, and they have just dominated the football. 9 minutes and 19 seconds to New Mexico's minute and 37.
It was flip-flopped a year ago when these two teams
exactly.
Were.
New Mexico has got to answer on this drive. They've done it each time Air Force has surged ahead. Let's see what they've got on this drive.
Manning in motion. Kelly play action. He's got his tight end, and Penley dropped it. He caught one earlier in the game, and this one he had some real estate to enjoy if he'd pull it in, but no dice, and it's second and 10.
Like Penley had about 7 yards of green grass out in front of him, surely would have gotten a first down. Smart guy, academic all-conference the last 2 years is Brian Penley. 3.53 GPA. That's impressive. When you think of the time demands that these young men have with their football, to have that kind of a grade point average is very impressive.
Kelly again. Air Force containing Adrian Boyd. Boyd's second grab of the afternoon. He gets 5 yards and set up third down and 5. For New Mexico, Baylor next week, and then the big one at New Mexico State. Bragging rights. There's certainly enormous games ahead on the schedule. Texas Tech, conference games, UNLV, Utah, BYU, Colorado State, but you've got to beat New Mexico State. Third down, about 4.5. Kelly again, has a man open, and it's counter, and counter. Gets the first down and more, out close to the 38.
What a block out on the outside that time. Beautiful little slip screen to Dwight Counter, getting it into the hands of their playmaker out on the outside. Look at that block by Penley on the outside. Coming from that tight end slot, he came out on the outside and just threw a beautiful cut block that sprung Counter for that first down yardage.
Offensive coordinator Dan Dodd told us they're going to throw deep a few times. We've not seen that yet, and they do have the wind to their back. There's a time to do it. It may be right away. Wright slips one tackle, but can't slip four others. And he struggles to get back to the line. Maybe a yard. Anthony Schlegel leading the gang attack. And three new receivers come into the game for Rocky Longs Lobos.
Schlegel's going to be a good one for Air Force for a long time. Just a sophomore. He was 13th freshman All-American last year. The sports writers.
Dontrell Moore into the game at tailback. Right. Catching his breath. Second down and about 9.5. Play action. Kelly is sacked. Air Force hasn't got to Casey Kelly a whole lot, but they get to him there, and John Rosinski makes a big play.
When Rosinski played that well, he didn't come free. Came and took on the blocker, put a vicious hit on the running back, and then stepped aside, went around that back to get that sack. Big play, very physical play by the linebacker that time.
Time ticking away here in the third quarter. And there will not be another play. Air Force hogged the ball most of the third. They got a 1-yard touchdown run, and that's the difference. After three, Air Force 31, New Mexico 24. Fourth quarter coming up here on Sports West. 31-24 Air Force leading New Mexico. Prior to kickoff, we thought Quincy Wright and Leotis Palmer would play big into the afternoon. Blaine, they have not disappointed.
Boy, Quincy Wright is a rare combination of strength and speed. You see him here going down the sideline. And not only has he run the ball effectively, he catches this screen and goes all the way for 6 points for the Lobos just before half. He has been impressive.
Leotis Palmer, the game's first touchdown, a 54-yard run right up the middle, and here it is. And once he got into the secondary, forget about it. He's going all the way.
Blaine,
he's throwing the ball, too, Blaine. What in the world?
He's shown us a couple of great throws. He threw one to a wide-open receiver on a halfback pass, but that throw back to Chance Herridge there was a pinpoint pass for a halfback. That was a heck of a throw.
Fourth quarter ready to begin. New Mexico, third down and 12 with the wind into the face of Casey Kelly. Air Force threatens blitz. They bring one linebacker, Kelly. Pass complete over the middle of the field for a big first down. And into Air Force territory, Terrence Thomas. First time he's made a play all day long. And Thomas captured by Hightower, but the junior out of Albuquerque comes up big when they need him the most.
And Casey Kelly showed a lot of poise that time. He stood in the pocket. Air Force was coming with a stunt, and he stood in there, knew that he had guys under his legs, and still had the courage to throw it out there and complete the ball.
Thomas out of West Mesa High School. And now the Lobos in Air Force territory for the first time in the second half. And it's right. Boy, he just evades defenders so well. Picks up a handful of yards. Rocky Long talked to us about the wait-and-see approach that he has. Get the ball, kind of wait and see, and then bam.
He's a patient runner that explodes when he gets going.
Here are the numbers through three quarters, presented by Quality Sinclair Gasoline with SG2000. It's simply unbeatable.
And look, the rushing yards, Air Force really piling up in that third quarter. So 202 yards rushing on the game now, 301 total yards with Leotis Palmer's passing performances. But a good game all around, one turnover on each side, two evenly matched teams. They're going to play right down to the line.
Second and six. Kelly the option. Close to a first down. Stopped at the 31 to be about a yard shy. Hightower, another tackle. Hightower's been all over the place today, along with Jeff Overstreet. For Air Force.
Casey Kelly, a pretty good sized guy. He's got a pretty big body, 6'3", 193 pounder running that option from the quarterback spot.
Third and one. So you got to figure that Mr. Wright is going to see the football. If he doesn't get it on third and one, they'll give it to him on fourth and one. He got it on third and one. Gets the nose inside the 30. And now Air Force with a very nice drive to counter the score, or New Mexico to counter the score from the Falcons. Thompson and Slagle on the stop.
Have you noticed that whenever New Mexico needs a short yard situation, they go right behind that right side of their offensive line? That's where their experience is. Jason Lenzmeyer at 6'5 and 312 pounds, a two-year starter, 20 consecutive starts at right tackle. Claude Terrell's having a great game, a 330-pound sophomore. They call him Big C. And I see why. He's a mammoth there at right guard.
Right again. Running right into the heart of the defense. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, and that is all. See Grady in there in the pile as they come up for air. Nicholas Taylor has had a big game, a junior out of Cincinnati, and Monty Coleman, a junior out of Phoenix. A lot of youth on the Air Force defense as well. We mentioned the young fellas for the Lobos. These Air Force defenders are going to be around for a while.
Yeah, especially that defensive line is a young group. Monty Coleman's a junior. He's got the most experience. 8 starts coming into this game. He's the most experienced on that defensive line.
Kelly going to throw it. Screen pass to Wright. And Wright's got real estate. First and 10 at the 10-yard line. Marsh knocking him out of bounds. That screen nicely set up and well executed.
Well, Quincy Wright point, hey, get somebody in here for me. I'm a little gassed right now. But New Mexico doing a nice job of this drive. A little of everything, throwing the ball up the field, running the ball inside. Now they come back to Quincy Wright on the outside on the screen. I'll tell you what, New Mexico's sending a message to the rest of the conference. If you're going to defend the Lobos, you better find out where Quincy Wright is on every play. Right now, he's on the bench. That's where Air Force likes him best.
Dontrell Moore is in. First and goal from the 10 for the Lobos. And Moore with the ball. He's cut down in the backfield by Rosinski. And Rosinski continues to come up with big plays here in the second half.
Rosinski, a very physical player. Takes on the blocker, comes through again this time. Making his read, scraping down. Look at him slide down from the backside and then take the legs out from under the running back. Good play by Rodzinski.
Moore stays in. Wright stays out. And it's second down and goal from the 12. So a loss of 2 yards. Kelly's got everybody going out for a pass here. Throwback to Manning. Manning, touchdown! Air Force has come up with big calls and big plays, and New Mexico has answered with plays you might not expect. Second and goal from the 12, and it's a comebacker to Manning, and Manning takes it in for his first touchdown of the season.
Well, and a great play calling series for New Mexico that time. They did a great job of mixing things up, a good mix of screen pass. They threw the ball up the field on intermediate routes. They were in the shotgun.
Here's Zunker to tie it at 31.
Well, Dan Dodd, the offensive coordinator for the Lobos, answers the Air Force yet another time here in this game.
So the battle continues, tied up at 31. Mexico goes 80 yards in 13 plays, 5:56. Manning a 12-yard touchdown. And the game is tied at 31. First Mountain West Conference football game of the season. It's moving up to its billing. And this is Blue from the 14. And he's up close to the 30. Cut down just before the 29. Air Force will have the wind to their back. And 10:53 to go in the game. Domingo Villarreal on the stop for the Lobos.
You saw Casey Kelly there talking on the sideline. Looked like he was pretty happy with that last drive. We've seen two very impressive drives. Air Force came out in the third quarter and just dominated the clock and had a great drive, and then New Mexico answered. Let's see what Air Force has here in store for their answer.
Been like a title fight. Herridge to Palmer, and Palmer's in trouble. Doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Renteria and the boys take him out, and it'll be second down and about 11. And the clock will continue to tick down. Very inexperienced field goal kickers on both sides today. Ashcroft has made a couple. And he'll have the wind to his back for Air Force. And Wes Zunker kicked one earlier on today for his first field goal of the season.
And the wind's still blowing out. They're not quite as intense as it was earlier in the game. So it's still a factor, but not as much.
Harridge rolls out. Close to Palmer. Over his head and incomplete. The second down and 10. And some activity after the play. Domingo J.O.R.L.
Chance Harris rolling to his left. He's a right-handed quarterback. You've got to get your shoulders around. The problem is, when you're throwing on the run like that to a stationary target, it's very difficult. You actually have to throw the ball back inside the receiver. Watch him roll to his left. You've got to throw the ball back inside because the momentum of your motion as you're running to the left is going to take that ball outside. And watch, he throws it at the target. The ball carries high and outside. You've got to throw it back inside as a quarterback when you're on a full run to your left.
Third and 11, it gives to the fullback. And Massey struggles to get to the line of scrimmage. And it's three and out for Air Force. Guillermo Morrison on the stop for New Mexico, who's going to get the ball back with a chance to take the lead.
Well, for the Air Force Academy, if you're Richard Bell, the defensive coordinator, the thing you worry about is your defense was just on the field for an awful long time during New Mexico's impressive drive on that last series. And they've got to be a little bit tired, a little bit frustrated. And they get just a moment's blow here, a moment's rest, and they're back on the field against a New Mexico team that's got some confidence right now offensively.
John Welsh in the kick, counter, back to receive. He returned to punt 63 yards for a touchdown last week. There'll be no return here. Not a bad punt offered up by Welsh. And the Lobos will have it on the 23. Game tied at 31. You're watching College Football on Sports West. We're back after a message from your local station. Punt, and New Mexico has the ball on the 23-yard line with 9:09 to play, and the game tied up at 31. Dave McCann, Blaine Fowler, great to have you with us on our season opener here on Sports West. And right around the left side, and he's cut down after about three and a half. Anthony Schlegel on the stop. Great help up here in the booth today. I want to thank Renee Carlson, Gil Boyson, and Daryl Lay for their help. It's always a privilege to come to Air Force and see the jets fly by, and everything's first class here. Fresno State and Oregon tied up at 10 in the second. San Jose leading the Huskies 10-0 in the second. Our Applebee's scores flashing on the screen. New Mexico back to work. Kelly fouls his own number, dives for a first down, out close to the 35. Charles Bucher on the stop. Hey, New Mexico showed a moment ago they can drive 80 yards and eat up as much clock as Air Force can.
Well, a very well-rounded offense the last couple series. That time, a great block by the tight end on the outside linebacker for Air Force, sealed right down and allowed Casey Kelly to turn that corner.
Rocky Long trying to make it four in a row over Air Force, something they have never done. Right straight ahead. And you wonder if the Falcon defense is getting tired of dealing with him. Another first down, 10.5 yards right up the middle. Mark Marsh pulled him down.
First down for New Mexico.
Marsh coming up. He's back there in the secondary. And when you've got Wright going through the defensive line and linebackers coming right at you as a safety, it's not a sight you like to see, and it means a first down for New Mexico.
Crowd clamoring for some defense. First and 10, Lobos, just shy of the 46. Right again. He's come to a complete halt. You see big number 72, Nate Hembree, is just holding him, leaning him forward. Trying to get as much out of the run as they can. They get 2 yards. Matt McCraney credited with the stop. It'll be second down and 8.
Well, in Air Force that time defensively, they put more people on line of scrimmage. And New Mexico's moving the ball, and you have to think that Air Force is going to have to respond to that. If they're getting knocked off the ball, you have to keep bringing more people on the blitz and take the risk that you have to cover man in the secondary to stop this attack of New Mexico.
We still haven't seen the long bomb. This is counter. Downer lost his footing, and then he lost some yardage. Dwight Counter ran for the touchdown on a very similar play, but nothing doing here, and it started with losing his footing right here.
Well, well played anyhow by Akinyemi on the outside, came up from that cornerback spot and really played it well. Ran right by the block on that screen pass, and we've seen that play work very well in the last series twice for New Mexico. That time it was sniffed out by the Air Force Academy.
Third down and 10 and a half, and the crowd on its feet. Blitz is on. Kelly in some trouble, throws it nowhere near anybody, but a flag is down in the New Mexico backfield. So often we see the holding call here, and it's holding against the Lobos. Air Force will decline it and make the Lobos kick into the wind.
And we just talked about that, Richard Bell, the defense coordinator. If the defense isn't happy.
Holding. Offense. That penalty's declined. Fourth down.
If the defense is getting pushed around a little bit, you got to bring more people. And he brought everyone that time. You see right there, if you're beat that time, looked like Claude Terrell reached out. He was beaten on the blitz, and for fear that his quarterback was just going to get smacked, reached out with his right arm and grabbed a hold of one of the linebackers for the Air Force Academy.
Tyler Goff to kick it. No doubt Air Force will come after it. Leotis Palmer waiting to receive it. Here they come. They get it off. A flag is down at the line of scrimmage. And Palmer from the 16. Across the 25. Air Force may have jumped off sides. And the flag is right in front of the Lobo bench at the line of scrimmage. 39-yard punt.
You know what would be a tough job? Is being the punt returner for the Air Force Academy. I wouldn't want to be Leotis Palmer.
It's against New Mexico, and let's see. They came very close to blocking it, and Fisher Deberry is going to make the freshman kick it again.
The reason I say that would be a tough job, Richard, because they come after so many kicks. They don't set up a lot of returns for that guy. And Palmer's standing back there just getting ready to be killed every time.
Offense. Not enough men.
Well, if you could make that out with the intermittent microphone. Not enough men on the line of scrimmage. You have to have seven guys on the line of scrimmage. You can have as many as you want. You can put 10 guys on the line of scrimmage if you want. But you have to have at least seven. And in that punt formation, New Mexico only had six. Somebody didn't slide up where they need to be on the outside.
So the freshman awaits the snap from Martin Lovato at his 25-yard line. Here they come again, and again they get it off. And this one off the side of the foot of Tyler Glass. And let's see where they spot it. Air Force is going to come out ahead indeed. And so that 5-yard penalty, costly for New Mexico. Falcons have the ball, 5:45 to go. We're still tied at 31. 5:45 to play in the game. Score tied at 31. Chance Herridge, 3 of 7, 29 yards, and a touchdown. Passing yards, Lobos up to 200, Air Force at 99. Massey, the big fullback, has 4 yards over right guard. It'll be second down and 6. And Blaine, as Fisher Deberry looks up at the clock, in theory, New Mexico's offense doesn't have to see the ball again if all goes according to his plan.
Oh, yeah. Air Force would love nothing more, and Fisher Deberry, than to take a 5-minute drive methodically down.
Look at this. A strange play to Leotis Palmer for a first down. Well, they're going deep into the bag.
We keep saying that they've used about all they have in the playbook, but evidently Air Force has a bigger playbook than we thought, because as soon as we think we've seen it all, they pull something else out. Watch this one. Herridge lines up on the ball and just sideways snaps it. This is a play that you drew up when you were a kid out on the playground. And he said, hey, I'll just run over. I'll just huck it over to you. We'll line up all the linemen on the right-hand side, and I'll just throw it over to you, and we'll do it that way. That was something you draw up on the playground. And the playbook is bigger than we thought, Dave.
First and 10, Air Force. And Herod's going to throw it. He's going deep, throws into double coverage, and he's fortunate that he overthrows it because New Mexico was in prime position to defend the ball, if not pick it off.
Looking for Anthony Park on the streak on that side, but New Mexico was not fooled at all. David Crockett was there in coverage.
Stride for stride, Crockett was. An interesting call. We've not seen Air Force go to their tight end, Adam Strecker, who they believe could be the best tight end ever to play at the Academy. He's been blocking, not been part of the offense. And give to the fullback, Massey, for 2 yards, DJ Renteria. And viewers at home may sit there and go, what in the world do you run that play for? Over and over and over again.
Well, and that fullback in this Air Force offense, you pound that fullback inside, you pound him inside, and that opens up the outside game, but also, every once in a while, somebody makes an assignment error on defense, and that fullback pops open for a 55-yard gain. They lull you to sleep with that, and they get some big plays out of that fullback spot. And New Mexico says they like to take away the perimeter, but they've done a very fine job on the fullback today.
Third down and 8. Herridge is in a lot of trouble. Scrambles away, gets a big block, and then throws it out of bounds. And the punt team will come on, give the ball back to the Lobos. Strother and VRL in there giving Herridge fits. That was well defended right from the snap. Air Force has a new punter into the game. Robert Barkers, and this is Barkers' first punt all afternoon. I have a strange time to bring in a new punter, but he kicks a beauty, and it's going to go into the end zone. And so the Lobos will be 80 yards from the end zone with 4:11 to play. Barkers comes in, kicks it 50 yards, and he goes out.
Boy, and they sent him in there. He hit that one with a lot of power. Perfect spot. He looks a little disappointed. I'm wondering if they didn't send him in because it wasn't going to be an awfully long punt to try to angle it into the corner, and he just hit it hard with the wind into the end zone.
And the Lobos, no need to mess with the huddle. They're ready to go right to work. From the 20, 4:11 to play. We've been tied for a long time now at 31. Right straight ahead. He's got 3 yards. Ran right into the big arms of Nicholas Taylor. So Air Force will have a week off to get ready for Cal. And then they continue the conference battles at Utah. New Mexico doesn't play another conference opponent until October 12th in Las Vegas against UNLV. And that series has turned into a pretty good rivalry where the home teams have done fairly well over the last couple of years. Second and 7.
It's movement along that New Mexico front.
And it'll be second down and 12.
Dead ball. Full start. Off. 5-yard penalty. Still. Second down.
Ken Rivera needs a new battery.
Yeah, he's breaking up on
it. In his microphone. 3:31 on the scoreboard clock.
As we've had shots of Rocky, he seemed very mellow on the sidelines today, doesn't he?
He hasn't been yelling at very many people, that's for sure.
And even on the block punt, didn't show a lot of emotion down there.
Kelly mishandled the snap, and they're going backwards. Loss of about 7. I think Kelly may have spotted somebody open and forgot to look the ball in.
You know what? Kelly was putting his mouthpiece in. I don't know if you saw that right at the beginning. He wasn't ready for that ball to be snapped. He was putting his mouthpiece in, and in that type of offense, you don't go on an audible count. Quarterback raises his leg when he's ready, and they allow the center to snap it when he's ready. Well, that center snapped it, Justin Colburn, and Kelly was still putting his mouthpiece in his mouth and couldn't catch it.
Air Force trying to win the field position war here in the waning moments. It's third and 17. It's Wright, and Wright has a lot of real estate. And Wright's across the 30. First down on third and 17. Quincy Wright gets 18 and a half.
Well, and again, you see the flat-out foot speed of Quincy Wright.
No bigger play than this
one. He turns over to the left side, and then watch the angles. It looks like Air Force has the angles. He just runs right by people, running past linebackers and defensive backs. That's Mark Marsh, who's fairly quick, a defensive back, 5'11", 205 pounds. He just runs away from the angle that Marsh has on him and gets the first down. 23 rushes, 140 yards.
And the ball is just shy of the 32 as we near the two-minute mark. And neither team's in a great hurry. Kelly threw behind the receiver, but Joe Manning reached back and pulled it in.
Kelly's pass is complete to Joe Manning.
Pass for 6 yards. You watch the clock up in the corner there. Ticking away. Everybody with timeouts. Air Force with two. New Mexico has all three.
But New Mexico just kind of not really worrying about the time here. You wonder if they're thinking, hey, let's just get it down into field goal range and win this thing with a field goal.
Kelly checking off with the assignments. Air Force blitzes. And Kelly is caught at the line of scrimmage and dropped. Marcello Grotti with a stop for the Falcons. And you've got to start to wonder why New Mexico isn't using any timeouts. It's third and three, but we're nearing the one-minute mark in the football game. And they are a long ways away.
Well, now it goes under 1 minute, and they just don't seem to be in any hurry at all or have any sense of urgency.
Third and three, Kelly. Lots of time, and he throws it incomplete. And it's fourth and three. And now what do you do if you're the Lobos? You got to kick it away.
You
45
punt.
Seconds left, but you got to question the last 2.5 minutes of ball management here.
Well, it just didn't look like there was any sense of urgency out there at all. And maybe the Lobos are content to go into overtime, but you can't go for it here in this situation. Too risky. You're tied up in the ball game. If you get a good punt off and hold Air Force, you go into overtime. If you gamble and go on fourth down and don't get it, Air Force is easily in field goal range with a couple of quick completes.
Tyler Goss, here come the Falcons. They don't get it. No flag, and Palmer calls for a fair catch at the 20.
Good punt into the wind that time.
Keep it right here with 38 seconds to play. You're not a throwing football team. I wouldn't be surprised if Air Force just puts a knee down.
Well, they may run some type of option play or something to try to spring a Leotis Palmer or Chance Herridge on a long run, but New Mexico's going to be sitting back in a prevent defense and trying to keep everything in front of them on the field. Maybe you throw a quick screen to the outside and hope that somebody can break a few tackles, but you certainly won't have much of a chance to throw it over the top on this play.
Well, an unheralded group that deserves some accolades is the special teams of New Mexico. And each time Air Force has come after them, they've gotten the punt off, both the freshman punter and their blocking scheme. That's something Northwestern wished they'd figured out in the second quarter of last week's game. So to give to the fullback. Massey entangled about. Flag flies. 32 seconds on the clock. A personal foul face mask against New Mexico. 15 yards for Air Force. Now that might change things.
Got on 35. I think that watches as Massey's running the football. If you tackle
personal
a man,
foul.
Look at
goes.
That. You tackle
face
a man
pass.
By the face.
Defense. 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
Is that Moss that got his hand on a
I think it was actually,
masker.
It might have been Bucher, defensive end. But when you grab it and spin the man around by the face mask, it's that 15-yard variety. And Air Force has a little bit of breathing room.
35-yard line. They still need to get a ways to have a shot at a field goal. Falcons with two timeouts. They've not thrown the ball effectively. They're not interested in throwing it here. And Herridge is across the 40. And Fisher Deberry calls for a timeout with 22 seconds to play. Air Force's version of the hurry up is Run it off tackle and send the quarterback around the corner. Fashola on the stop. Timeout, Air Force, at the 40-yard line. It'll be second and six. Joey Ashcroft has kicked two 35-yard field goals in his career at the Academy. So you got to figure he'll have a pretty strong wind to his back, Blaine. How close do you think Air Force needs to get for a legitimate shot?
Well, I think that to anything 45 yards in, they'll go ahead and attempt. And that's still quite a ways for this Air Force offense to move the ball in 22 seconds. They're at the stage now, when they were deep in their own territory, you don't want to gamble too much. You're at tied in ball game. You're going to have a chance to go to overtime. You don't want to risk turning the football over where New Mexico can just turn around and kick a field goal without even gaining any yardage. Now they're getting out kind of on that borderline area where, can you know, do you want to do something risky here? You don't really want to do something risky. You want to call a play that you're sure to either complete the ball or complete the play and not put the ball on the ground and turn the ball over.
The face mask penalty is what has turned this into a potential last minute drive. 22 seconds left. From the 40, second and six. Palmer in motion. Delay handoff to Palmer. Looked like he might have fumbled it a little bit, but he's regrouped. He's into New Mexico territory. 15 seconds left. The clock will stop while they set the sticks, and Herridge is going to spike it.
Yeah, Air Force has one timeout left, and you want to save that to get your field goal team on the field if you have that opportunity. So he'll spike it right now.
And there it is. 2 seconds go off. There's time for one more play, maybe two if it's fast, and then the kicker.
Well, if you're Fisher DeBerry, you got to talk to your home clock guy, because when they're spiking the ball, that was a quick trigger finger there. You would hope to only lose 1 second spiking the ball after a first down when you're at home. On the road, you can lose three.
Interestingly, before the game, Fisher DeBerry told us they're not even going to send the field goal kicker out unless they're inside the 25. That's his range. We're here, they're just trying to get a few more yards. They give him a shot at winning the game. And Herridge intercepted! Picked off at the 38-yard line by DJ Renteria.
See, and for Air Force, you're at the point now, field position-wise.
It's Spiegel, not Renteria.
In terms of field position, you're okay to turn the ball over there. New Mexico's not in automatic field goal range. New Mexico would still have to move the ball quite a ways. But that ball thrown well behind the receiver that time. In fact, I'm not sure whether he was throwing it to the guy in the flat or the guy further up the field. He had a man in the flat wide open that time that he should have gone to on the sideline and Tom Heyer and may have tried to throw the ball up the field.
Nick Spiegel, he forced a fumble last week against Weber State. And he has picked off a potentially game-saving pass. Although there was still plenty of work for Air Force to do, even if that was a completion. But with 6 seconds left to play, one must wonder, New Mexico was not in a big hurry the last 2.5 minutes they had the ball. And I'd be surprised to see something crazy here. Why do it here when you wouldn't do it when there was plenty of time left in your drive? But they have not gone deep all game. Kelly can throw it deep, although he's missed his man on the long ball several times here in the early stages of the season. But he'll be throwing into the wind.
Well, and in terms of field goal into the wind, the wind's picked back up a little bit. You would think New Mexico would want to get the ball at least to the 25-yard line before they feel even remotely comfortable. So they've got to advance the ball about 35 yards to be in range here.
Joe Manning and Dwight Counter are their alleged big play guys. Let's see if they come up with one here. Kelly under pressure, and he's sacked. And regulation will end. Nicholas Taylor with the sack. And we're going to overtime, tied up at 31. You're watching College Football on Sports West. Back after a message from your local station. Welcome back. It seems only appropriate, the first Mountain West Conference game of the year, and we are in overtime. The Lobos won the toss. They decided they wanted defense on the field first, so Air Force will send their offense out to the 25-yard line. Blaine, explain the rules.
Well, each team gets an additional timeout in the overtime, and it's run just like a regular game situation. Air Force can still get a first down, and whatever points they come up with, They will have, and then New Mexico will have an opportunity to have an offensive series as well, and they'll alternate until somebody wins.
Herridge calls his own number, dives inside the 25 to the 23. A pickup of two, be second down and eight. There's no sense of urgency now. There's no clock, no hurry. And so you will not see passes where you'd think you'd see runs. Air Force will try to settle into their offense, and you got to figure we're going to see plenty of Quincy Wright when New Mexico gets their offense on the field.
Well, and the advantage of taking you always take defense first. New Mexico made the right decision because then you know what you have to do. If Air Force comes away with nothing, then you know all you need is a field goal to win the game. If they score a touchdown, you know you have to match.
Herridge again, diving close to a first down. Be about a half yard shy. Renteria on the stop. And Chance Herridge lowered his head and took off.
Well, and teams practice for the overtime. They work out in their minds, offensive coordinators, if we get into overtime, here's the new playlist that we want to go for that are our best plays in overtime. And you can bet that Chuck Peterson for the Air Force Academy and Dan Dodd for New Mexico have a game plan in mind for this overtime period.
Third and one. A big hole off right guard, isn't it, for Herridge. He decides to keep it. This is Leotis Palmer. And Palmer has the first down, and he's inside the 10 to the 9. A nice cutback by Palmer, who is now up to 124 yards on the ground. Quincy Wright has 140. Those two have been working hard all day long.
Boy, in that one, Herridge got the pitch out quick. Didn't even look like it was a read. Looks like it was a called pitch. Pulled it out of the center and got it immediately out to Palmer on the outside. Palmer, as predicted at the beginning of the game, having a big game, a leader here for the Air Force Academy. If you have the ball first, you have to score a touchdown. You want to go down and score a touchdown to really put the pressure on the opposing team to match your score.
First and goal from the 9. Herridge to the 5. Down to the 4. There's Southam right there. That's the cannonball champion of the world right there, the center leading the way. Spiegel on the stop. Southam at 255. Everyone else 275, 295, 290, 280. But Southam is your typical Air Force lineman.
He is a scrappy competitor. He's a cannonball. He'll roll you over down in there. You mentioned earlier in the game a Mormon returned missionary. Went to Frankfurt, Germany on his mission and came back to the academy.
Second down and goal from the 4. Herridge to its fullback. Massey, touchdown. Steve Massey's first touchdown. Why do you run that play? Because when you really need it, it might be there for you. 4 yards into the end zone, and Air Force has the lead in overtime.
Well, double team on the nose that time by Southam and Heiser, the left guard, opened up a big hole.
Very important kick for Ashcroft. He is perfect on the season. John Welsh, the holder. And the kick is good. So the pressure shifts to New Mexico. They've got to score a touchdown and kick an extra point to stay alive.
Now you can, as the team going second, if Rocky Long decides that this is what he wants to do, if New Mexico were to score, he could elect to go for two and win the game in the first overtime. Or he could just tie it up as we look at that touchdown again. Look at the hole created. Massey gets those pads down and takes it into the end zone. But you can go ahead and kick the extra point, tie it up, and go into a second overtime. So
you saw Wiley at 185 trying to keep Massey out at 230 with a head of steam, and it's just not going to happen. So here comes the Lobo offense, down by a touchdown here in overtime in Colorado Springs. Welcome to the Mountain West. Kelly throws back, and it's caught inside the 20 to the 19 goes Joe Manning. They've worked that play a handful of times today, and it's good for 6 yards before Matt McCraney could pull him down.
Boy, and how good a catch was that by Joe Manning? I mean, that was not a well-thrown ball. It was back inside. Manning was coming back, and the ball was thrown out in front. Watch him grab this with his hands. He's actually going to stab back at the ball. That was one heck of a catch. Then he maintained his feet and picked up some blockers to get a gain of 8 yards on the first down.
Rocky Long told us before the game the talent is even on these two sides. It'll just come down to who executes. Here's Wright straight ahead. Pulled back shy of the first down. He gets close to the 17.
Well, the one advantage you have on the New Mexico offense right now, you know you have to score a touchdown. So every situation is a four-down situation. This is third and one. You're not thinking if we don't get this as a low-ball offense, we're gonna kick a field goal. You've got right. Two downs to get a yard.
They need to get right to the 15, and the ball is resting just outside the 16. Third and one. Wright is getting ready. Kelly to Wright. First down. Inside the 15 to the 14. So a new set of downs for the Lobos. Monty Coleman on the stop. And Quincy Wright, 265 a week ago against Weber State. He's come back against a pretty good Air Force team, and he now has 145 yards. Ninth in the country in rushing before today, and he'll be up much higher once the stats are compiled tomorrow. Here we go again. Option. Kelly keeps it. Falls forward for a yard and a half to the 11. Rudzinski there defensively for Air Force. See the big back of Nicholas Taylor, the nose guard. He's been in on a whole lot of plays today. And there's Rudzinski. Ball resting just outside the 10, second and 8. Lobos can get a first down on the 3. Kelly back to pass, in some trouble. He's lucky it wasn't intercepted. Well defended by Air Force. They wanted to get Quincy Wright the ball on the outside, and if that lineman had been looking, that ball was coming right for him.
Boy, and Air Force coming with an all-out blitz this time, and it was read well. You see Schlegel sitting there at the inside linebacker position. He made his read. He had the running back, and as soon as he saw that running back release, Schlegel went over on the screen. And so Casey Kelly, a lot of pressure in his face from the blitz, and a perfect read by Schlegel at linebacker prevented that completion.
Third and 8. And it's going to be third and a little bit more. There's some movement on behalf of the Lobos. The sophomore, Nate Hembry, out of Carrollton, Texas, moved too early. Now it's third and 13, and the Lobos need to get to the 3. Blitz is on. Kelly, incomplete, intended for Dwight Counter. Wouldn't have been enough for the first down, but would have cut the deficit in half. And now the game comes down to this. Fourth down and 13, fourth and 16 for a touchdown. And the fans that are here that have been sitting in the sun now enjoying cloud cover, and they are on their feet. And timeout has been called as New Mexico prepares for perhaps their final chance. Timeout on the field in overtime, 38-31 Air Force, and we're back after a message from your local station. Welcome back to Colorado Springs, Air Force leading 38-31. New Mexico, fourth down and 13 from the 16-yard line. They can get a first down at the 3. The game will end if it's anything less than that. Kelly has men over the middle into the end zone. It's incomplete. And Air Force wins. Force had blitzed on the two previous pass plays. They didn't blitz this time. There was plenty of time for Casey Kelly, and nobody open.
Well, the coverage was very, very solid, and Kelly waited. When he finally elected to throw it, he had pressure down low at his feet. And Air Force doing a great job. They mixed it up on defense on that series. As you mentioned, the two previous plays, they had come with a blitz. Richard Bell called a drop off that time, and the people in coverage did a good job for Air Force. Take a look. Just trying to get the ball down the middle of the field. Brought one backer and dropped everybody else in coverage, sitting in the zone down the field.
Not sure who he was throwing to. It wasn't near anyone but Joel Bielow.
Joe Bielow deflects it down the middle of the field, and Kelly started to feel the pressure at the end there as nobody opened up and threw the ball down the middle.
Fisher DeBerry's expression as the last play, and this game meant a whole lot to him. He has snapped a three-game losing streak to Rocky Long. The Falcons now snapping that streak. You see Rocky Long. And New Mexico will slip to 1-2 on the season, 0-1 in conference play. Their next conference game is at UNLV in October. A very difficult road ahead for the Lobos. Not easy for Air Force either, but they have Colorado State and BYU at home. They play Utah in a couple of weeks, and they've started it off with a very, very big win to open conference play.
Well, Fisher DeBerry, as we talked to him yesterday, said, we really want to get this early conference game under your belt. You want to win that one so you can sit back and play some non-conference games and just take a breather a little bit and say, okay, we're okay for right now here. You're one up on everybody else. So he's got to be very pleased with the way his team fought this afternoon here in Colorado Springs.
Listening to some of the tradition and pageantry here at Falcon Stadium.